stadium. We apologize for the audio problems that we had a little bit earlier. It's the Cal Bears and the Arizona Wildcats. Barry Tompkins along with Tom Ramsey and Carol Lewis. We are just about set to go on a chilly night here. This is a series that probably is most marked by its unpredictability. Here is what they call the circle at Arizona. Gets the guys all charged up. Dick Tomey felt his team was a little bit flat coming into games earlier in the year. So they started this, which is something that they do at practice. They put one guy in and one guy out, and they try to knock the guy who is in out. Pretty simple stuff. Well, we talk about the unpredictability of this series. Last year, of course, typical of it, and it really was a fourth overtime game that caused a rule change this year. 35-35 at the end of the game. And then, in overtime, Keith Smith, the quarterback for Arizona, to Jeremy McDaniel. McDaniel, a redshirt this year because of a preseason injury. Touchdown. That made it 42-35. Back came the Cal Bears. Pat Barnes, the quarterback, looks for Damian Douglas. Finds him on a perfect pass in the end zone with the conversion. 42-all. Arizona not done yet. Keith Smith this time. An 11-yard run. Touchdown. 49-42. Back came Cal. Pat Barnes, play fake. Looks for Mark Vera's tight end. Into the end zone. That ties it at 49. And still it wasn't over. This time, it's Barnes. Looks to the end zone. Throws caught once again by Vera. 56-49. Arizona tied it. Tried for the extra point, but it was a fake. It was no good. And in four overtimes, California wins it 56-55. In the last nine games, just 34 points difference in these two teams, within these two games. 56-55 last year, 55 points, the second most ever by a losing team in NCAA history. It did cause a rule change because now, in the third overtime, you have to go for a two-point conversion. Well, California comes in here this year, no Pat Barnes. They have a new quarterback, Justin Vetter. And the best thing that Vetter can say about this season is he's got a guy to throw to who is awfully tough and has broken just about every record at Berkeley. Here's Carol Lewis with more on that.
Thanks a lot, Barry. And you talk about Justin Vetter, and when he's looking for a big strike, he's looking for the senior wide receiver, Bobby Shaw. He's had an excellent season, and last week in his last home game as a Cal Bear, he became number one on the Cal all-time receiving list with 172 receptions. It moved him up to number five on the all-time Pac-10 list, and nationally, he's sixth in receiving and fifth in receiving yards. Needless to say, Justin Vetter is going to be looking for Bobby Shaw an awful lot tonight. Barry?
All right, thanks very much, Carol. And of course, another Cinderella story on the Arizona side of the ball, and that is the story of Ortiz Jenkins. He's a guy, Rams came here really as a basketball player who played some football. All of a sudden, he's a football player who's playing some basketball.
Ortiz Jenkins has really stepped in, and we're going to see him right away tonight. He stepped in for Keith Smith, who was injured and was ineffective at times, but Ortiz Jenkins has really been the team leader thus far for Arizona.
So we are set to go. There's Ortiz Jenkins. Arizona wins the toss. They want the football right now. Rodney Williams will be the deep man along with Northcutt. And Brache will kick it off for California. It's headed in the direction of Northcutt. He drove the ball pretty good. Northcutt will not come out. And Arizona will start at the 20-yard line. Arizona, we should point out, still with a possibility of being bowl eligible, despite what for them has been a rather disappointing season.
Yeah, you have to get six wins at NCAA Division I in order to be eligible for a bowl game. There's so many bowl games out there, though, they may not get elected, but even though if you win their last two games, you got a great start into next year's season. And of course, both teams want to win the next two crucial games.
Here's a look at Ortiz Jenkins. OJ, they called him. 51% completions. Look at those bottom two numbers, though. That is impressive. 16 touchdowns, only two picks. One of those picks, actually, was a Hail Mary at the end of the game. He's a gamer. He's a guy who didn't show much in practice, very frankly, but he comes into the game, and he's big time. Here's Northcutt on a reverse on first down, and he's got no place to go. The Bears wrap him up. Beck, first man to him, back at the 16-yard line. Let's take a look at Arizona's offense. Trunk candidate will start for the first time in several games. 107 yards a game rushing. That is good news. He's about 95%, according to the coaching staff, with Ephon Williams, Northcutt, who just carried the ball, and Lucky, the tight end. Jose Portilla playing his last game here before the home folk in Tucson. And he's got size, as you can see. Here's a look at Trunk candidate. Candidate just a sophomore out of Phoenix. Came in as a co-number one with Leon Callen. Callen's redshirting the year out with a preseason injury. Play fake, and OJ will go up. Throws, and it is dropped by Lucky at the 25-yard line. It was going to be short of the first down with Sekou Senyika defending. Here is the way California lines up. Brandon Whiting, clearly the catalyst of this team, getting better as the season goes on. 23 career sacks and about a 3.5 grade point average to go along with all of that. Matt Beck is back and healthy at the middle backer spot. That has been a real chasm for California defensively and has caused them some problems, but they feel a healthy Beck will help. Marquise Smith, the leading tackler on the Cal Bears and third in the Pac-10 Conference, but that too. That area, the secondary, has been a problem. Jenkins will go up, throws, and it is intercepted by Marquise Smith. And Smith gets it back to the 27-yard line, and the Bears are in business. And now a fumble, and I think they, let's see, no single yet. They're giving it back to Arizona. How do you like that? It was going to be a turnover, and Bears ball deep in Arizona territory. Tom Holmo doesn't quite agree, Rams.
Tom Holmo is hot. And Ortiz Jenkins, if there's one thing, when he comes out of the gate and a little excited, he tends to throw high. Tom Holmo is hot over there on the Cal sidelines, and he should be.
We're going to have a little discussion amongst the officials here, so let's hold it for just a moment.
I thought we heard some whistles as they were dragging down Marquise Smith. See right there, his forward progression has stopped, and then they ripped the ball out. Rusty James, the big center there to fall on.
Nonetheless,
bear down Arizona. They retain possession.
Go ahead.
Ortiz Jenkins just trying to get a crossing route over the middle. He fires the ball way over Dennis Northcutt's head, and Marquise Smith makes a nice play. But right here, well, right there, his progress was stopped, and that's when the ball was ripped out.
So a first down on the change of possessions. Big break for the Wildcats. They give it to Kennedy. There's a reverse for Northcutt. Northcutt at the 30. Got a little room. 35, 40. Look out. Midfield. 45 and into California territory at the 43-yard line. A flag, however, is down back at the line of scrimmage, and I suspect this is going to come back. I think we have a holding. Just underway, 13-32, no score, Cal in Arizona. We've had two turnovers on the same play. An interception, which you will see, and then the fumble, and Arizona got it back. We just had a long run by Northcutt, but that's going to come back too.
Yeah, no better play right there than get the ball back after a quick change of possession, but to run a reverse to Dennis Northcutt, the wide out.
Offense, 15 yards from the spot of foul. Repeat first down.
So the 15-yard penalty is going to be marched off against Arizona. And this game starting out like a couple of teams that are not in sync, which I'd say is probably pretty accurate.
Cal actually comes in the most penalized team in the Pac-10 thus far. Arizona stride for stride with them.
So after all of that, Arizona will have it first down and a million at the 17-yard line. It's first and 26. Three wideouts, slot right, with Brennan in the slot. He's been their go-to receiver in tough situations. They give this time to Candidate. He's got a big gap to the 25 to the 30-yard line, and he got a bunch of that back, got about 14 back. Pete DeStefano makes the stop, and it's going to be second and 12.
Trunk Candidate still one of the conference's top rushers, and he's been out for quite some time. He's missed the last 3 weeks due to an ankle injury, but right there, you see his explosiveness. He's getting up the field. Watch the interior. The offensive line doing a nice job. Just a quick hitter. Brandon Whiting, 48, takes himself out of the play, and then Candidate takes a hard hit by DeStefano, the free safety.
Just want to remind those of you who are watching Texas A&M and Oklahoma, we will, of course, keep you up to date on the progress of that game as it goes along. Here's Jenkins throwing, caught this time by Williams. All kinds of room. 45 midfield, leads a block, gets it from Lucky at the 40. Cut back to the 35, the 30, down to the 28-yard line of California.
Coaches come in tonight. They want big plays. They want things to happen down the field. And in order to make big plays happen, you have to get blocks down the field. Right here, Ortiz Jenkins shows great patience. It's a free safety blitz. Number 20 gets picked up by Kelvin Ethan. and the middle is wide open. Rodney Williams watching, pick up the block by 88 Mike Lucky. Doesn't get him on the ground, but he picks up an extra 20 yards right there just with the effort.
42 yards on the play, and that's coming back from a first and 26. So Jenkins again with that ability to make the big play. Ball at the 28. Bears show blitz. They come with it. It's picked up. Jenkins floats it out there for Northcutt and threw it a little wide. Cats did a pretty good job of picking up the blitz that time.
They did a great job recognition-wise, although Ortiz Jenkins has to know when you're getting max blitz and you get protection, you can take a little extra time and lay the ball out in front of the receiver. That time the ball just carried the receiver out of bounds.
So it'll be second down, the ball just short of the 28-yard line. Dick Tomey, winning his coach in Arizona history, struggling through this season a little bit, but still, as we said, his team could wind up better than 500. Candidate gets the outside, 25-20, it's a foot race, he's gone. 10-5, touchdown, Cats.
Trung Candidate looked as though he got shot out of a cannon right then. Great blocks on the perimeter. They're able to seal the outside, and the Cal defense just gets caught up in the middle. Nobody there on the edge. DeStefano gets beat, and Trung Candidate, no one's going to catch him. He's sprinter.
Doesn't play like he's hurt, does he? 28 yards on the touchdown run by Candidate. And the try for Point McDonald. Is up and good, and with 11 minutes and 46 seconds remaining in the first quarter, a very impressive drive by the Wildcats. They lead it 7-0.
You've done the math and figured out that you can consolidate bills and still afford to make some home improvements, but the lenders tell you that you don't have enough equity. Hi, I'm Dan Marino. If this has happened to you, call First Plus Financial at 1-800-510-PLUS. They'll lend you up to 125% of the value of your home, less your first mortgage balance. There's no application fees, and you'll get an answer before you hang up. Don't listen to those other lenders. Call First Plus at 1-800-510-PLUS.
You've been quiet.
I was talking to Okpik.
Okpik?
He's an Inuit.
Inuit, huh?
He lives a long way away.
Well, so how do you talk to him?
With this.
Tell Okpik hello.
Okay.
With the easy access button on the new compact Presario, we're changing the way you get on the internet. The compact Presario 4800 series with Intel Pentium 2 processor.
Why does she play field hockey? She knows there will be no shoe commercials, no trading cards, no limos. So why? Because she is an athlete. Just like a football player, just like a basketball player, just like a baseball player. GTE is proud to be the official telecommunications consultant to the NCAA in the Pac-10 because of her and the pure spirit of college athletics.
Rather easy 67-yard drive puts Arizona on the board. They lead it 7-0. The 28-yard run by Trung Candidate was the difference. And he just, this will track me, Rams.
Well, and they haven't had that explosiveness for the last 3 weeks. Trung Candidate's been out with an ankle injury. Looks to me as though he's healed himself as he rolls and tumbles into the end zone.
Well, they got hurt in the game that we did here on Fox against Stanford, and was in tears on the sidelines thinking his season was over. And you can see what he's done rushing the ball this year. He makes the big play, doesn't he?
Absolutely. That 96-yard run is the longest run from scrimmage this year in the Pac-10 conference.
So they're on the board. 67-yard drive, but remember they went backwards to the 17-yard line. So really they went 83 yards on a 67-yard drive. Delta O'Neill will be the deep man for California.
And interesting, Cal came out blitzing them early, blitzing the young quarterback Jenkins, and he was able to respond.
He just gets it done, and that's what the coaches say too. Here's a pop fly kick headed for the up man, and it goes out of bounds at the 25-yard line. The Bears will get it at the 35. Well, so far, I suppose you could say the Arizona offense has clicked, but the game itself is not one that you would likely put in a time capsule.
Free kick, out of bounds against the kicking team. The penalty's accepted. Ball will be placed on the 35-yard line.
Dick Tomey's special teams have really been a problem. He said his special teams is really responsible for as many as 50 points against Arizona this year. And that is very uncharacteristic of an Arizona football team. It's always been one of their strengths. But this year, everything that could go wrong has. Here's a give this time to Tarik Smith. And Smith gets about two. Jimmy Sprott makes the stop. Justin Vetter is the quarterback out of Saddleback Junior College coming in this year. A high percentage completion percentage, but the 12 interceptions is something that he would like to have back. He has struggled in the last four or five games. Very mobile quarterback, strong arm. And of course, Bobby Shaw is his main target. Bears want to be 50-50. Run pass. Here's a hitch for Shaw. Makes the catch to 40. It'll be close to the first down, about a yard short. Marcus Bell makes the tackle. Let's take a look at how California lines up offensively. Bobby Shaw, as we said, has already been the record breaker for California. We got a flag down, incidentally, in the secondary. 67 catches, over 1,000 yards so far. Damian Douglas has come on a little bit as well. John Welborn is the real experience on this offensive line. Jeremy Newberry back at the center position after playing guard against Arizona State. So right at the moment, it is an offensive line that is a work in progress for California. This is going to go against Arizona, a personal foul. And it's going to give Cal a ball deep in Arizona territory, or well into Arizona territory at the 42-yard line. Tom Holmoe, again, one of the good guys, not real worried about this year. He's thinking, yeah, I would have liked to have done better, but we're setting a tone here. Here's a give to Smith. He gets into the open at the 30, at the 20, at the 10, to the 5, and stopped at the 1-yard line. Chris McAllister makes the stop, and this is starting to look like a track meet.
These kinds of games are interesting because both teams, this is a very important game. Throw out the records, each team going into their rivalry game in a week, but this game will give them momentum as they break into next week's game. But right there, Jimmy Sprott tries to make the play at the line of scrimmage, but Tarik Smith just hits the hole 100 miles an hour, gets down to the 1-yard line.
41 yards on the carry for Tarik Smith. Bears in the offset eye. Give it to Smith. He's in. Touchdown, California.
The good news for Cal, they've been hampered by a lot of penalties this year, Barry. Right there, they put a nice drive together, and I asked their coaches coming into the game, they lead the conference in time of possession, which I'm real big on, but they haven't put up the point production that you need to with that kind of time of possession. But right there, they did what they had to do. They consummated the drive, good execution, and they were helped out by a penalty.
Yeah, and the giveaway takeaway for California is not bad either. They're minus one, and they're 3-6, and Tommy Holmoe really feels, when we talk to them, that this is a better football team than the record would indicate. Try for point by Wallach is up and good, and this game is tied. Tarik Smith getting 10-2 on the sideline, might have cramped up a little bit after that long run. Here's the touchdown run.
Yeah, stretching out his hamstrings, might have tightened up on the long run, but right there he gets a nice block by the fullback up over the top. Joshua White, number 40, gets his hat on the linebacker. Just creates a big hole for Smith, who's up and over for the 6.
And just like that, a 7-7 ball game. One of the Wildcats is down on the field also, injured back at the 5-yard line on that extra point attempt. We'll try to identify him. So 7-7, and we've not yet played 5 minutes. Injured Wildcat is Daniel Greer, and that really does not bode well. Daniel Greer had a broken leg last year in the game against Arizona State, and we were talking about that earlier amongst ourselves, and one of the cheapest shots I've ever seen in college football, and don't like to see him get hurt prior to the Arizona ASU game, which is always one of those emotional kinds of games. An emotional kind of game, incidentally, that both Dick Tomey and Bruce Snyder are making special effort to keep the emotion on the playing field and not anywhere else.
There's already a lot of pressure on that defensive line. They can ill afford another injury to that D-line. Daniel Greer, of course, the injured player, but Mike Sloco, really the main cog in the wheel there for that defensive line. not to mention Joe Salovea, but Sloco out, has missed a couple games this year. He's out for the rest of the season with a back injury, and really he makes other players play out of position. Dick Tomey, I don't know who he's looking for on the sideline.
I have an idea. He might be looking for a stretcher. As they again tend to Greer, and Greer, as we said, a broken leg in the battle against Arizona State last year while he was standing in the end zone cheering on a teammate from some 50 or 60 yards away. And obviously Dick Tomey really cares about his players, very concerned. Dick had his seniors over to his house for dinner just the other night. We welcome you to Arizona Stadium. Barry Tompkins, Tom Ramsey, Carol Lewis, Cal and Arizona tied at 7. We want to welcome those of you who are watching the Texas A&M Oklahoma game, where the Aggies just blowing out the Sooners 51-7. 10 minutes 26 seconds left in the first quarter here, and an injury on the playing field right now to Daniel Greer has caused a momentary delay in the game, and that is the leg that Greer broke last year, and he does appear to be able to put a little bit of weight on the leg, and that is always a good sign. But Daniel Greer has made a remarkable comeback to just get this far, and now he gets injured on an extra point of all things. So Greer will be helped from the team, and Dick Tomey, I'm sure a little deja vu running through Dick's mind right now. These two teams have been in something of a track meet so far, each with a long drive and scored very quickly. Here's Arizona's first touchdown.
Ortiz Jenkins handing off to Trunk Candidate, who just catches the edge of that Cal defense, and he's off to the races for the first score of the game.
California coming right back, however, after a 41-yard run by Tarek Smith. It was Smith again from a yard out for the touchdown, and the conversion made it 7-7. As we said, we've only played 4.5 here. So the Bears will kick it away. Brache will kick off for the second time in this ball game. Williams is the deep man. High end over end kick. It's going to be Northcutt at the 3-yard line to the 10. And stopped short of the 20-yard line. Good coverage on special teams that time by the Cal Bears. They mark it at the 19, and that's where Arizona will begin. A 16-yard return by Northcutt. Here's a look at Daniel Greer on the sideline while they continue to tend to him. We will get a report certainly on the injury to Daniel Greer. Ortiz Jenkins out of the shotgun on first down. Give the Candidate to the short side. And Candidate gets across the 20 to the 25, a gain of almost 6 yards. James Gibson makes the stop for the Bears.
And what's interesting, before the game, I was speaking to Homer Smith, the offensive coordinator of that Arizona team, and he said, we're going to be good tonight. We got a lot more things going on and happening. They're going to be playing awfully well. The full package, the full arsenal is in for Arizona. And Ortiz Jenkins, who missed training camp, pretty much he was practicing at wide receiver, has taken command of this offense for the Wildcats.
So it'll be second down and 4 now. And again, good first down yardage for the Wildcats. Straight ahead, Trunk Candidate again. Slips a tackle, gets close to the first down, and I believe he's going to get it. Well, so far it's been all offense. Brandon Whiting, Marquise Smith on the tackle for the Bears, but two rushes and a first down for the Arizona Wildcats.
And remember the quarterback that Ortiz Jenkins replaced, Keith Smith. We'll see him tonight at wide receiver. We may see him at quarterback as well.
Jay Hinton, who rushed for 114 yards replacing Trunk Candidate last week, is in the ballgame at the running back spot. Play fake this time, and Jenkins will throw, slips and falls back at the 20-yard line. Tubenio was the guy putting pressure, but Jenkins just slipped and fell, just that simple.
Awuko Tubenio, number 58, really the rush end for the Cal Bears. He creates the play because he gets such a strong rush up the field. The guard comes out to try to block him, and he slips the block, and he puts the added pressure onto Ortiz Jenkins.
Keith Smith is in the ballgame now at a wide receiver spot. He's lined up in the slot to the left side. Remember, he's a former quarterback. They go out of the shotgun again on second and a whole bunch. Jenkins with time, steps up, throws, caught by Smith. Smith slips a tackle at the 30, at the 35, to the 36-yard line. Pickup of 16 on the play. Kato Surwanga, Matt Beck make the stop, but the former quarterback proving an able receiver.
How good is Keith Smith? He lines up in the slot, they play him with bump coverage, and he shakes the guy on bump, and he's able to get up the field for the first down.
Arizona Stadium's the scene, 7-7 ball game, 7:55 remaining first quarter. Arizona and California, Wildcats driving again, looking at a third down and a short four. They go out of the shotgun once again. They run out of the shotgun almost exclusively. Jenkins will put it up, throws and overthrows Brennan, and I think there was just a little confusion there, and I'm not sure Jenkins knew who he was throwing to.
Yeah, I had a little confusion myself. I was saying first down, and they just got a good third down and three there. But again, Jenkins early on in the game, a little nervous. He tends to throw high, but once he gets settled down, he's able to spin the ball in right where he needs to put it.
So they will punt it away. Chris Palak, who was a walk-on, came on a couple of weeks ago after an injury to the starting punter. Delph O'Neill will be the deep man for the Bears. Bears show a 10-man front. Try to kick this away from O'Neill, but can't. O'Neill makes the catch, gets by the first man, tries to get the outside at the 35. Still on his feet at the 40, and almost broken at the 42-yard line. So with 7:29 remaining in the first quarter, we got a tie ball game. Arizona 7, California 7 in all offense so far.
Why are jockeys considered athletes? Don't the horses do all the work?
One-on-one sports. Sports talk 24 hours a day. Get ready to score with Fox Sports Net's College Football Saturday. All season long on Fox Sports West.
The new Nissan Altima GXE has more horsepower than a Camry LE. It comes with a standard CD player, unlike the Camry. It's a whole $2,100 less than the Camry. But perhaps the best reason for buying the new Altima? It's not another Camry. The new Nissan Altima.
Don't expect too much from yourself, Michael.
Start on varsity.
You can't play at the level of North Carolina.
Be realistic.
Forget the team. Think of yourself. Why go back to basketball? You'll embarrass yourself.
Had enough?
Just getting started.
Boy, you throw form out the window in this series. I don't think there's any question about that. Bears lead at 9, it's 9-7 with two ties, and the underdog has won 6 of the last 9 games. That's pretty much the story between these two teams, and this one is starting out just like the others.
Yeah, it can't go to a 4 overtime game, though, because last year, you're right, it set a new precedence in the rules. After leading into the third overtime, if you score, you have to go for a 2-point conversion, so you don't have the monster game that these two teams had a year ago.
Well, I remember the coaches were telling us that the players were just dog tired at the end of that game. So Justin Vetter starts now for the Bears. He'll go up for the first time looking for Shaw, and he overthrows him at the 30-yard line. Closest man to it actually was Rashid Johnson of Arizona.
Tell you what happens when you have a great receiver like Bobby Shaw, you tend to go to the well too often, and that's what happened to him. The Cal coaches said, hey, he got so accustomed to going to Bobby Shaw, who's making the assault on the record leaders in the Pac-10, that He just kept dwelling on him, and he wasn't spreading the ball around enough to the other guys in the offense.
So it'll be second and 10. Play fake, and Vetter will go up again. Throws underneath this time for White out of the backfield, and White will be close to a first down. I believe he got it into Arizona territory at the 46-yard line. Joshua White, who sat out the last game because of a disciplinary measure, and it wasn't a big thing, but Tommy Homo was just kind of setting a tone, you know, saying you follow the rules or you don't play on Saturday.
And a week ago, the fullback position caught five balls. Mark Vera, the backup, caught five balls on plays just like this, coming out of the backfield, spinning the ball out, and getting up the field.
Pitch this time to Smith. Smith, the left side, stopped at the line of scrimmage, and a flag is down. Marcus Bell makes the tackle, and now we'll see about the penalty. Bears had 21 penalties, and now they're going to get another one in their first game against Houston. That is an unheard of number. It's the most in the Pac-10 conference by any team this year. And they won the game big.
Holding on the offense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Repeat the down.
I want to welcome those of you who've been watching Detroit and the New York Nets. Final score there, 96-88. Detroit wins at New Jersey Nets, I beg your pardon. New York Nets haven't been around for a few years, have they? Barry Tompkins, Tom Ramsey, Carol Lewis. We're at Arizona Stadium here in Tucson, Arizona. 7-7 ball game, first quarter. They give this to Joshua White, and he stopped for a loss. And a pretty good size loss at that, a couple anyway. Back at the 43-yard line. It's going to put the Bears in a second and big. Deshaun Polk and Joe Tafoya on the stop for the Wildcats. It'll be second and 21.
And Deshaun Polk really has to play big because Sloco is out and not able to play for the Wildcats. Deshaun Polk really becomes the playmaker for that Arizona defense.
Justin Vetter straight back. Blitz comes. He avoids the first man. Now he's going to run. He's got some room in midfield for the 45 and slides down at the 41-yard line. Well, they got a lot of it back, and it's going to be third down now at about five. Vetter has that ability to turn a broken play into something big.
And who does Arizona bring off the corner? They bring Deshaun Polk, and Vetter is able to sidestep him, and then he does the wise thing, as you said, Barry. He's got some great feet, and he can do just that. Get you out of trouble, get the ball back up the field, and give you a chance at a third down.
Well, they mark it a little bit shorter than it appeared to be, so it'll be third down and seven. Vetter checking off here. Short drop this time. Blitz comes. He throws. It is caught by Douglas, and Douglas is going to have the first down at the 31-yard line. Nice checkoff that time by Justin Vetter.
Damian D1 Douglas right there out of Hanford High, Hanford, California. Damian's having a good year. He really has gotten after it, and he demands the ball. He wants the ball thrown to him. I was able to stop by the Cal Hotel last night and sit down for dinner, and D1 came by and said hello. He's never shy to come say, hey, say hi to everybody in Hanford for me. I said, you got it.
Well, the things you'll do for a free meal. Catch show blitz again. They come with it, and they give this time to Tarik Smith. Smith runs over his own man, picks up about four. David Phipp makes the stop.
Tarik Smith, they're really looking for him to just springboard into action. He really started off great a year ago. He was hurt, and right now he rotates with Marcus Fields, number four, a true freshman. But don't go with the hot hand. Tom Homo not afraid to put Tarik Smith back in the game. He just wants productivity from that tailback position.
Well, they want Smith to play at least two series, and then they'll let Marcus Fields go until he gets tired. Blitz comes. Vetter's got no place to go. Flags down, and Vetter is dropped for a sack back at the 32-yard line. Chester Burnett was coming, and there was nobody to block him. And a hold against California, the call once again. So the Bears going backwards here. We'll see if Arizona takes this. It would be third and 11 if they don't, or if they do take the play, rather.
Holding on the offense, penalties decline, third down.
So they decline the penalty, and it is, in fact, third and 11.
Well, they ended up tackling Joe Salavea Watch as he tries to, on the snap of the ball, center just tackles him, draws the flag. That's a takedown.
Slot right this time on third and 11. Better straight back. He throws, and he throws much too wide. Intended for Bobby Shaw, right at the first down mark at about the 20-yard line. So the Bears now will have to think about what would be a 49-yard field goal or just go for it here. It appears the decision is they will go for it.
And some of the kickers warming up that came out early for the Cal Bears were booming some field goals. And it's interesting, though, the home field coach, Dick Tomei, asked him before the game. I said, hey, you only have 8 field goal tries the whole game. He says, hey, we like to go for it on fourth down, and that's what Cal's doing right here.
I don't think that's by choice. I think it's by necessity. That may be the case here, too. Better straight back. Slips. Now he steps up, throws, and throws too wide. Intended receiver Bruce Pierre took a real shot out of bounds from Kelly Malva, Chris McAllister.
So the Bears give it up. Wildcats get it back. 4:25 left. First quarter. Arizona 7, California 7. We're coming back.
I had always had an interest in science. I mean, I had a telescope, and my dad and I used to sit outside at night and look at stars and planets. And I just didn't feel like it was something I was any good at. My physics teacher convinced me otherwise.
Isn't that beautiful?
It just gives you incredible self-esteem, motivation. You just feel great because you're thinking, I discovered this.
The University of Arizona, education for a lifetime of discovery.
Fox Sports has a long tradition of innovation.
As a tackle fire!
You can see that same spirit in every Fox Sports News show.
End up in that hot zone.
Because our goal isn't to give you just a score, a highlight, or a stat.
It's about trying something new, something different.
It's to take you closer to the story than ever before.
Let me ask you about that third down call.
Got those with something low and away?
At least that's the plan.
I don't want to shake the guy guarding me. I want to own him. First I roll up on him, then back up on him. Do a reverse, fake him out. Then he'll freeze like a deer caught in the headlights. That's when I take my shot. Bam! Nothing but net.
The Kings wrap up the homestand when they face Chris Chelios and the Blackhawks. The puck drops Thursday at 7:30 on Fox Sports West.
4:25 left, first quarter. We're tied at 7. We go to the field to Carol Lewis. Carol.
Thanks a lot, Barry. And a little update on Daniel Greer, the junior defensive tackle. He hurt his right ankle. He said while his foot was extended, someone fell on it. Now they're icing it, and they're going to tape it back up and see if he can return. Barry?
That really is good news because, as we said, he suffered a serious injury last year, came back from that. And the good news is there are no broken bones or anything like that. Candidate gets the call and gets some room, gets to the 42-yard line, close to a first down. Matt Beck makes the tackle. Candidate running hard.
Fresh legs. That's all. That's what it is. And really dominant at the line of scrimmage. The Arizona offensive line really pushing around the defensive line of Cal. And Tom Holmo said coming in, the defensive line was playing really some of the best ball on his team that they all year long.
Jerry,
really come along.
Jerry DeLurch not in the lineup tonight. He is normally a starter. Andre Carter, the freshman, about whom so much has been said, one of the number one recruits certainly of California, one of the best recruits in the country. 4.5 speed, 245 pounds, and he's bulked up a little bit more than that too. His dad's here, Reuben Carter, tonight. He's a coach at Maryland, but Maryland has a bye this week, and so he is in the stands watching his son Andre play. And he's going to be a player, according to everyone that we've spoken with.
Oh, he tested out as an incoming freshman as higher than any freshman ever coming in, I think, in probably any program. Height, weight, 40 time, vertical jump, shuttle run. He will be a phenomenal athlete. And at 280 pounds, he might be light.
Amazing. Short of the first down, and to give this time to fullback Efon, and he's going to be stopped short. Matt Beck right there to wrap him up, so it's going to be third and short now. He actually lost about a yard.
It's scary when you say the average size. You know, you say 280 pounds is small, because you look at that Arizona offensive line, they're averaging 6'5", 318 pounds. I mean, that's a lot of Big Macs up there.
They got some bulk. And there it is right there. 346, 302, 296. Rusty James, the baby of the group.
Yeah. And I got to tell you, those guys, they're always pushing. They're giving you the lighter weight. I guarantee you they're heavier come game time.
Third and short now. And Jenkins will go up. Throws right open, Kennedy. He dropped the ball. If he catches it, it's a touchdown. And even just going to his knees, it's a first down.
And I don't know if I put that so much on Trunk Kennedy. He says, hey, my fault, but Ortiz Jenkins does not throw a ball with a handle on it. He just throws it hard out in the flat. It's an awfully tough catch, but if he just spins him the ball lightly, he's off to the races.
So from second and short, the Cats will have to punt it away. Delph O'Neill will be the deep man. Jenkins now 2 of 7. And O'Neill, I don't think they gave enough room. I think that's going to be one of those flags, at least, is going to be a violation of the 2-yard rule. Kelvin Hunter might have gotten there too quick, but there are 2 flags down, so we'll see.
As the ball comes down, you got to give them 2 yards to catch the ball. They may call a clip
or a trip on California.
Yeah, interesting when that flag did come out.
Well, we're going to find out here.
Illegal block in the back against the receivers. The 10 yards from the other kick. First down.
There you have it.
All right. We'll have that zone dive.
And again, California going backwards here.
Mike Waffle, the defensive line coach, there talking to his defensive lineman. Saying, see the whole picture. Watch what they're doing. He wants them to run stunts and execute up front. That's what you have to do. Right now, they're getting beat at that line of scrimmage. The Arizona offensive line taking control.
Marcus Fields is in the ballgame for the first time at the tailback spot for California now. Better will go up on first down. He throws, open as Douglas, first down and out of bounds at the 31-yard line. D1. 13 yards on that pickup.
What's interesting, when Cal was driving down in the red zone before, Barry, they went for it on fourth down, but they went after the heart of that Arizona defense, which was Chris McAllister. They're going against one of the top corners in the land, and awfully gutsy of Cal.
Give it to the fullback, Joshua White, trying to get outside, taking bodies with him, but even with all of that, he only gets about 2. Chester Burnett hanging on.
Chester Burnett just keeps impressing me year after year. For the last, this is the 3rd year in a row now, he has led the Pac-10. He's been in the top 3 in tackles with big games like that. 20 tackles, 17 unassisted versus Cal a year ago. And he's had a couple 20 tackle games. He had a big game against Ohio State earlier this year.
2nd and 8, better to put it up. Throws, and that was a tough catch. And that's one of those plays that I'm sure Joshua White will go back to Justin Vedder and say, don't throw it like that.
Boy, college football, just listen in on this one as Marcus Bell comes and just puts the whack on the running back in the flat. Ouch.
So it'll be 3rd and 11 now. 4-yard loss on that pass play. Vedder straight back. Blitz comes. They pick it up. Vedder trying to roll away. Throws. Caught by Douglas. Did he get the feet in or one of them? Yes. Great play by Damian Douglas. 14 yards and a bare first down.
Fundamentally speaking, not what you want to have your quarterback doing, running backwards and throwing the ball up the field. That's an issue with the coaching staff, but Damian Douglas tiptoes. And he actually gets 2 feet down. Makes a great catch right in front of Dick Tomey for the first down.
It's an NFL catch. They bring Shaw in motion this time. And Vedder will go up again. Blitz comes. Screen. to Vera, and Vera will get it to about the 47-yard line. It's going to gain about 4 yards. Rashid Johnson makes the tackle for the Cats.
It's interesting when you look at Cal's offense this year. They came out of the gate throwing the ball an awful lot. Vedder had two tremendous games. They jumped out to 2-0. Then all of a sudden they lost a couple games and they got conservative in a way. They started rushing the football a little more. And then they said, hey, wait a minute. Let's just go back to that West Coast offense and open up the playbook and look at what we're supposed to be doing.
He's going to try to fool people. Here's a give to Marcus Fields. Nothing doing. He is cut down by Joe Salavea. Salavea, great story. This is senior day here in Tucson. And interestingly enough, this is Salavea's second senior day.
He's a veteran at senior day.
That's right.
Oh. And he got that by, he came in as a special admit, ended up finishing school. It's a great story in 4 years, and he actually earned himself an extra year of participation in the Pac-10. And what's more remarkable, he wanted to come back and put in another year at Arizona.
Well, this, as we said, is a senior day, and Dick Tomey, when we talked with him, said, I don't need any big speeches. This day just kind of carries itself.
A senior's last home game is a big deal. And it's a big deal for the senior. It's a big deal for the rest of the team, because the rest of the team would like very much to see the seniors go out as winners in their last game. And so that will be a very, very emotional experience for our guys.
Here's a look at Dick Tomey pacing the sideline. It's been a real up and down year for the Arizona Wildcats. He's got a couple of his better players redshirting the year. Jeremy McDaniel, who caught one of the touchdown passes that you saw a little bit earlier in the four overtimes last year against California, redshirted because of a preseason injury. Leon Callen, who actually was going to be their starting running back, also had to redshirt with a leg injury, and Trunk Candidate has stepped in smartly on that. A lot of freshmen, Glover, Tafoya, Anthony Thomas, so this is a relatively young Arizona team. Well, we're there when you're looking for the stories, all the sports inside and out. Fox Sports News is coming up tonight after the game. Check your local listing. Justin Vedder slips and falls, another sack, and he will go down back at the 37-yard line. Second sack of the ball game. Anthony Thomas was the guy who was coming. We talked about the freshman. He is another first-year freshman who's getting some playing time and being productive for Arizona. So Rodney Williams will be the deep man to receive this punt. Nick Harris is the punter. As the Bears look at a 4th and 17, it's interesting. This game started out all offense, and it's
Arizona
winding up with an awful lot of defense. Wildcats didn't have the proper bodies on the field, and so they called a timeout with 33 seconds left in the first half. And the Bears will come to the sidelines, and so too will the Wildcats. Well, next week on College Football Saturday, Southern Miss Golden Eagles will travel to Memphis to take on the Memphis Tigers, or Tulane will go to Houston to do battle with the Houston Cougars. That's next week on Fox Sports Nets, College Football Saturday. Check your local listings. Justin Vedder started out prior to California's first loss of the year. He had won 19 games in a row, and Tommy Homo said, you know, he's a guy who felt like he was bulletproof for a long time, and all of a sudden, something that he's not used to, and that is losing football games, and it's been a bitter bullet for him to bite. Very difficult not winning, and he's just now starting to get back into sync.
Yeah, you really have to take the good with the bad, especially in the Pac-10 conference. Both teams have lost to Washington, Washington State, and UCLA. Cal also losing to Arizona State. And those four teams are the front runners for the Rose Bowl. Arizona, of course, having to face Arizona State in their final game on the 28th.
And they're going to need some help to get to the Rose Bowl. Rose Bowl picture clearing a little bit, but still pretty muddled. The only thing that was decided today is that Washington is out of it. Harris drives this kick pretty good, but Williams might have some room. Back at the 11-yard line, he starts back to the far sideline and gets turned around and dropped right back at the 12.
Excellent coverage by California. Derek Gardner makes the tackle. So the Bears special team is winning that battle so far today. 52-yard kick by Harris, and good coverage by the Bears.
I think you look at the youth of both teams. We've addressed it. Cal returns a lot of players next year, and of course Arizona returned a lot coming in this year. Take a look at Keith Smith as he lines up at the quarterback position, but Arizona has had its share of injuries this year.
Jenkins has struggled, 2 of 7, and now it's Keith Smith at quarterback. This is not a surprise. He throws, caught by Candidate. Candidate is stopped on a good open field tackle. Rather, Kelvin Ifon stopped by Matt Beck. And the Wildcats will go without a huddle now, as there's 2 seconds, now one, left in the first quarter, and they're not going to get the playoff. And with that, the first quarter will come to an end. With the score, Arizona 7 and California 7. Coming back to Arizona Stadium after this.
Who's the big man that slams the world with just one hand? You damn
acting right. Is being.
Can't quite put my finger on it. Something just ain't right. That's what I've been missing.
Don't even think about it. Pepsi, Generation Next.
Please.
Nah.
The 98 Corolla. It's all new and it's available now. The redesigned Corolla has a sporty new look, more power, and best of all, Corolla is priced to sell. Be the first to drive home a new Corolla from your Toyota dealer today.
I heard my door close and I ran out to the truck, and this guy is standing there with a case of beer in his hand, and he tells me, he goes, oh, I was putting it back. My days are usually 10 to 12 hours a day. Come in here, get my invoices. From there, I get out on the road, start delivering. You see people, you go into the bars and you see people drinking, and you think, that looks good. I wish I could have one right now, especially on a hot day like today. It's a tough job, but I love it.
If our double-double were any larger, you'd have to watch it on a big-screen TV.
In and out, that's what a hamburger's all about.
We start the second quarter. We are tied at 7-7. And Rams, that number that you always talk about, time of possession, is as even as the score. 7:20 for California, 7:40 for Arizona, and 7-7 on the scoreboard.
Boy, and there are things that counterbalance that time of possession, like penalties and turnovers. We've had a few.
So Keith Smith at quarterback as we start the second quarter, looking at a second down and 8. Knows the football just across the 15-yard line. They do everything out of the shotgun now here. Smith straight back with time. Airs it out as Ifon throws it behind him, flag down. Matt Beck is going to get a face guarding call, I think. That's the matchup they wanted. Ifon on the middle linebacker.
Ifon, another two-sport athlete, a basketball player, and he does have some great moves and can throw a hip on you. Matt Beck coming back from injury. It is a face guard, and he will draw the penalty on the interference.
Two penalties on the play. Holding against the defense, that penalty's refused. Pass interference against the defense. That's 15 yards, first down.
Well, you know a team is being penalized too much when they get 2-on-1 play.
That happens to the most penalized team in the conference. The insertion of Keith Smith here into the offense, just trying to pick up the pace for that Arizona team. They were a little lackluster. Of course, Jenkins 2 for 7, but Keith Smith knowing and how to run all the controls of the Arizona offense.
There's Smith on a quarterback draw. He can screw it at the 30, at the 35, to the 37-yard line. Goes down hard over the Arizona bench, but he's all right. Right now, let's take it back to the studio. Kevin Frazier with a game break. Kevin.
Guys, earlier today up the road in Tempe, Bruce Snyder and the Sun Devils trying to get back to the Rose Bowl. Mike Martin scooting through the hole. He's gone. 83 yards. Will he get in? You better believe it. Forward motion. He rolls into the end zone. 52-31. Solomon Wilcox and I will clear up the whole Rose Bowl picture in a few minutes.
Thank you, Kevin, and I'm glad you guys will be clearing up that Rose Bowl picture.
I want to tune in for that one.
That's right. Kelvin Ephon was the ball carrier while we were away. Gain of 7.
That Rose Bowl picture has a lot of ifs and buts and a couple ands and ors.
Beg your pardon, no gain on the play by Ephon. It's going to be 3rd down and 4. Smith to throw, rolls to his right, got some room, throws downfield, got Brennan out there, knocked down. Brennan wants a flag, and so does the crowd, and really, I'll tell you, it wasn't unlike Matt Beck. He was right in his face.
Derek Gardner makes a great play, but you want the receiver to come back to the football. You want him to come back to the quarterback right here. It's a very difficult throw, and Gardner does a great job of getting his head around. Brennan was looking for the interference call, but the ball hangs just a little bit. Gardner's able to make up ground and make the play.
So the punting unit back on. Delph O'Neill, the deep man for California, stands at the 30-yard line. Bears play run back, and Pellick sticks this one. It's going to drive O'Neill back to the 14-yard line where he calls for a fair catch. Excellent punt that time. 56 yards on the punt. So the Bears will start at the 15-yard line. Just underway, second quarter, tied at 7. Tuesday on Fox Sports Net, don't miss a behind-the-scenes look inside the NFL on NFL Total Access. That's followed by Hardcore Football with featured guests Kevin Butler, Trevor Maddock, Leslie Shepard, and Gilbert Brown. It's NFL coverage like no other network. That's NFL Total Access and Hardcore Football. Check your local listings. Vetter's in trouble. Has to roll away. Steps up and is dropped for another sack. Back at the 11-yard line. Anthony Thomas, the freshman, just all over Justin Vetter. Vetter's under siege.
Asked him to do something that's very difficult. Roll to your non-throwing side, and that even slowed him up a little more and allowed Anthony Thomas to come in and make the play.
So the Bears immediately in a 2nd and long, 2nd and 14. They give us to Tarik Smith. He stopped for a loss. Deshaun Polk stopped Smith for a loss of 2. And it's going to be 3rd and 16. So the Bears going backwards.
And we've talked about the West Coast offense. The West Coast offense is quick hitting, high octane, and high efficiency. And the running game is a very big part of it. But you have to have production and get up the field. And you don't want to have 3rd and 16s in any offense, much less the West Coast offense.
Right now, the West Coast offense going south. Single setback, 4 wideouts, double slot. Vetter has to hurry this throw too and can't get the ball to Bruce Pierre, the intended receiver. Kelly Malvo covering, but ball was thrown much too far. So the Bears will have to give it up, and the catch should get good field position here. Tom Homo trying to find an answer.
Yeah, he wants to be going the other directional, which is north up the field.
It's the 2nd week in a row that the Bears offense has really sputtered. Last week against Arizona State, the defense actually played pretty well, as they are tonight. So Harris to kick from his own end zone. Williams stands right near midfield. Short kick. Williams at the 43-yard line gets down to the 37. Excellent return by Williams. And great field position for the Wildcats when we come back. 12:41 remaining in the half. We're tied at 7.
Rodney Williams with the return.
Data. Statistics. The stuff of instruments, gauges, and stopwatches. What if you were to buy a car strictly with your left brain? If that car was the new Mazda 626, your right brain would be handsomely rewarded. The all-new Mazda 626. Retooled. Refined. Reborn. Lease a 626 LX. $239 a month.
Implications socioeconomic maladies would have in a capitalist environment. I wonder who started the end zone victory dance.
NFL Total Access. Ron Pitts and Tim Green show you who's hot and who's not in the NFL. Plus, get wired in and hear what the playmakers are really up to.
I wonder if the Jets can win the Super Bowl.
NFL Total Access. Tuesday, followed by Hardcore Football on Fox Sports West. Fox Sports News at 10. We are there. First for the whole story.
Some serious NFL news out of Dallas.
You gotta be proud of this ball club.
We're not afraid to do whatever it takes.
Fox Sports News at 10. We are there live for all the latest home team updates.
Let's go live.
Live. Live. Live to Pittsburgh.
Fox Sports News at 10. We are there.
This is big.
First, fast, live. Fox Sports News at 10. The Grizzlies meet the Lakers, Sunday at 6:30 on Fox Sports West.
Pac-10 football on Fox Sports Dan is brought to you by GTE, the official telecommunications consultant for the NCAA. By First Plus Financial. At First Plus, you'll get an answer on your home loan before you hang up. Call 1-800-510-PLUS. And by Velo from Philips Magnavox, the power of a computer in the palm of your hand. Jenkins back at the quarterback spot now for Arizona. Give to Kennedy inside the 35. To Benio and Beck make the stop for the Bears, but a gain of about four on first down. Brandon Manamalayuna in the ball game now as they go to a double tight end set. Second down and six.
And Brandon Manamalayuna will be 18 years old on January 5th.
Really a linebacker, and that's where his position will ultimately be as candidate gets cracked short of the line of scrimmage. Stopped right at the 35 by Tubenio and Albert Dorsey. Keith Smith comes back into the ballgame now. I beg your pardon, Brennan back into the ballgame. There's Tubenio. Mawuko Tubenio out of De La Salle High School. And that high school, of course, just broke the nation's longest winning streak. They won their 73rd straight. Out of the shotgun once again. Jenkins, the quarterback, straight back with time. A lot of time. Airs it out deep this time. Caught by Lucky at the 15-yard line. Seku Sanika defending, but Lucky just stayed with it while Sanika didn't really look for the ball.
Watch Mike Lucky. He's going to line up, and he's going to take off and run an outside route. What ends up happening, Jenkins looks off the defensive backs in a great way. Comes back to Lucky, who's streaking up the sideline, and Lucky makes a nice catch. He caught a touchdown a week ago from Ortiz Jenkins. 13 catches on the year.
Going to get a timeout called by California here. This is their second timeout. And both teams will come to the sidelines and talk it over en masse with their coaches. We'll jump off the track as well. 11:20 remaining in the half. Arizona driving. We're tied at 7.
Among America's great universities, only one takes 95% of its freshmen from their high school top 10%, offers the most top-ranked graduate programs, and manages to keep tuition under $5,000 a year. Of the 10 best universities in America, only one is a public university. The University of California, Berkeley, keeping the promise of public education.
You're in a hurry.
Hey, you can't close the deal with dirt on your heel?
Totally stressed.
A little brown on those toes will keep it off your nose.
And now you're rushing to the gate for first-come, first-served seating?
You try.
On Shuttle by United, all seats are assigned seats at check-in, so you can stop and smell the polish.
Hey! Get over here and clean up those stinky shoes!
You're something else.
And right now, in California, there's a phenomenal occurrence going on.
Oh, yeah, did somebody say McDonald's?
Observe the groovy McRib sandwich for $1.49. A tender pork patty blazing with hickory barbecue sauce. Care for a taste? Tangy pickles and zesty onions riding on a toasted bakery roll. The McRib sandwich, only $1.49 for a limited time. McDonald's, it's hip to your taste.
Coming up at halftime, Solomon Wilcox will join me, and we'll have scores and highlights from across the country, including UCLA and Washington trying to settle that wacky Rose Bowl puzzle out west. It's all coming up at halftime, but right now, let's head back to Tucson, where Barry Tompkins and Tom Rams are taking care of business. We'll try and figure this thing out for you guys.
All right, thanks very much, Kevin. I kind of think the Rose Bowl may not be settled until there's nothing left but turkey bones. Jenkins at quarterback starts under center this time with Cannon at the lone setback. He gets the call straight ahead, not much. Stopped right at the line of scrimmage by Tabenio, who has been everywhere for California. Tabenio just a sophomore. This is a young California team and really is one of those teams in the Pac-10 Conference that I believe to be a team of the future. I think Oregon falls into that category, and I think the real scare card is so does Arizona State, and they're pretty darn good this year as you look at their makeup. There's only 15 seniors on the California team and only five who really get any appreciable playing time. Second and 10, and the give is to Kelvin Ifon, and he's going to be dropped for a loss. So the Wildcats kind of pulling the horns in here. Albert Dorsey makes the stop. A little ripple of boos going through Arizona Stadium.
Yeah, the Cal defense that time really stuffing the run at the point of attack in the line of scrimmage. And that play just slow to develop. Dick Tomey shaking his head a little bit. What quick hitters down in the red zone. And they tried to pull some backside guards. Albert Dorsey, number 44, just clogging up the middle.
Slot left this time as they bring Brennan into the slot. They go out of the shotgun with Ifon the setback. Jenkins straight back, looks to the end zone. He's got Brennan there, and Brennan was held up. I don't know if there's going to be a flag. There is no flag, but Brennan clearly got held up. I'm not sure we get a replay of that or not, but Chidi Uwoma was defending.
Chidi Uwoma did a nice job. Again, the play slow to develop, Barry, and it's interesting. This is where Ortiz Jenkins has been so good, down in the red zone. And give credit to the Cal defense. They stuck with their men in man-to-man coverage and were able to apply a little bit of pressure. Ortiz Jenkins throwing the ball just a little quick and off the mark.
McDonald tries the 35-yarder. It would be the longest field goal of the year, and it's not there. Interestingly enough, Arizona's longest field goal this year was 33 yards. That really puts the pressure on your offense.
Yeah, and I spoke to Dick Tomey about that before the game. I said, well, you know, what's been the deal? He said, you know, when we get into the red zone, I give Homer Smith, I let him know we're in four down territory because we really are better running our offense than trying to kick field goals right there, as evidenced. Probably wish he would have gone for it on fourth down.
And McDonald's not a happy camper right now. That really does put a lot of pressure on the offense because you've got to get the ball really inside the 15-yard line to make your field goal kicker effective. Flags fly before the snap. And that's going to go against California. California already four penalties for 40 yards, and now here's another.
Dead ball. Ball start on the offense. 5 yards.
That has really plagued the Bears. Incidentally, California, since its opening drive, which resulted in a touchdown, has had only 38 yards of offense. So the Bears really have gone dead in the water.
And that was an interesting call. Jeremy Newberry, the center, just kind of moved the ball and they threw the flags before anyone got set.
Give this time to Tarik Smith, and Smith is stopped after a gain of about two. Got it to the 18-yard line, but it's going to be second down. And about 12, maybe 13. And there is a Wildcat down. It is Salavea, and he has spent much of this season being banged up. He's not 100% coming into this game. He's a warrior. Joe Salavea. Let's take a look at the Burger King summary, how this game has gone so far. It looked like it was going to be a track meet as each team scored on its first possession. A touchdown run by Candidate of 28 yards. Smith reels off a 41-yarder and closes it with a 1-yard run. Jenkins and Smith have alternated at quarterback for Arizona. That's not a surprise. What is Deceiving, however, is California's 101 yards, because as we've said, since that opening drive, for all intent, the Bears have gone backward. Arizona with 136 yards of offense.
And what's interesting, Cal all year long, Barry, they've really not developed breaks of their own. They've gotten the ball in more or less bad field position, and they've had to drive the ball for awfully long periods of time, which actually correlate over to their time of possession, had a very long time of possessions. But it just asks a lot of that offense to sustain drives. Salavea is still down and looking at his left leg right now.
Joe Salavea has had a very tough senior year in terms of injuries and just being banged up. He really has not been 100% since the opening game. And this one is causing him some discomfort. But this guy defines the term warrior. And if there's any way that they can patch him up and get him back in there, I assure you, Joe Salavea will be back in there. What a reminder that coming up at halftime, we'll take you back to our College Football Saturday studios. Kevin Frazier and Solomon Wilcots will tell you exactly who, why, and what about the Rose Bowl. Who's going if this happens, if that happens. We're going to be listening to that. Big Ten race is also still up for grabs. And Tennessee and Arkansas getting it on tonight. That's all coming up at the half. Gore versus Clinton, Tennessee and Arkansas. It's a stretch, but I like it.
Boy, Peyton Manning, they're still touting him for a Heisman, but I think there's a guy in the Pac-10 conference up in the state of Washington that is making a run for it. Also, Ryan Leaf has done his share to sway West Coast voters.
I think he has. I believe the Heisman Trophy was given to Peyton Manning last year. Salavea being helped from the field, although there's a lot of speculation amongst a lot of people that you and I know in the football business, and that Peyton Manning, as good as he is, and I believe he will be outstanding at the next level also, may not be the first quarterback taken. Well, Tuesday on Fox Sports Net, a reminder, don't miss Behind the Scenes, Look Inside the NFL on NFL Total Access, followed by Hardcore Football. Features guests Kevin Butler, Trevor Maddich, Leslie Shepard, and Gilbert Brown. It's NFL coverage like no other network. That's NFL Total Access and Hardcore Football Tuesday on Fox Sports Net. Check your local listings for the times in your area. 7-7 ball game here. A game that really has had two different looks. It started out like it was going to be an offensive battle, and it has turned into a grind-it-out kind of give-yards-grudgingly battle as Joe Salavea grudgingly comes out of the ballgame. And the Bears come to the line of scrimmage looking at a second down and 12. Three wide-outs, single setback for California. And to give this time is to Tarik Smith again. Nothing doing, lost a yard. Deshaun Pope makes the stop, and that'll be third and long.
And what you have to really realize is that Arizona is playing without three of their top defensive linemen. Joe Salavea out, Daniel Greer out, Mike Sloco out, and that's a front that has been number 10 in the nation in rush yards allowed. 97 rush yards per game. What it means, Barry, is that they're playing with a lot of substitutes right now, and Rich Ellison, the defensive coordinator, has to plug a lot of holes.
Doing a good job with it, too. He's linebackers are flying to the ball here. Straight back to pass again. Better, he throws, got a man, it's Kofi Nardi. Short, well, might have been there. Might have gotten there at the 30-yard line. Kelly Balbo made the stop, and it's going to depend on the spot, and I believe it's going to be a California first down. Nothing fancy about that. Vetter never looked off Nardi for a minute.
Nardi, what he ends up doing, he's going to run a square out. And Vetter, just this is a nice timing route. He gets the ball out. Nardi able to get up the field and just enough for the first down.
So the Bears convert a third and long. They go out of the I formation now. Slot left with Shaw in the slot. Vetter throws underneath. Intended for Shaw, threw it too hard and too wide.
This is one of the things of that West Coast offense. Again, be patient. Justin Vetter, it was interesting the analogy that Coach Tom Holmo painted Vetter a couple weeks ago. He said, hey, Steve Young, when he was winning MVP awards in the NFL, got into a slump. You have to work yourself through it. You got to be patient. You got to go back to your reads and what the playbook dictates. Vetter sometimes gets a little anxious and beyond himself.
And that was one of those times right there. Here's a short side pitch this time to Tarik Smith. Smith gets a gap, flag is down. As Smith gets to the 37-yard line, a gain of about six for Tarik Smith, but I think it's coming back. It is. Another hold, another penalty as the Bears self-destruct yet another time. Joe Salavea on the sideline being tended to. Tom Holmo, a guy who he really believed this team was going to be a little bit better
Bowling
this year.
On the offense, 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Repeat the down.
But things have just not gone his way, and this is one of the biggest reasons.
Tom Holmo looks great. He doesn't have many gray hair, but I guarantee you, another year like this with all these penalties, he's going to have a head of full of gray hairs.
I think he thinks this team is really on the cusp of being a pretty good team, and I'll tell you what, I kind of agree with him. Straight back Vetter again. Throws underneath this time. It's caught by Douglas in traffic, and Douglas can only get to the 25-yard line. Gain of four. It'll be third down and about 15. Kelvin Hutter defending.
A great play that time because it can beat man or zone. Watch as Douglas will come dragging under. They're sending the tight end down the field, and if they read man, Douglas continues. If it's zone, he sits it down right over the ball. Vetter knows that. Gets the ball to him, gets up the field.
But still third down and 15. Blitz comes. Vetter has to unload in a hurry. It's caught by Douglas and dropped at the 40-yard line. Douglas had it in his hands. Ball was thrown to the wrong side, but Vetter had to throw it in a hurry. And it was a catchable ball for Douglas, who just couldn't quite hang on.
The ball was just a shade behind him, but you got to come down with that one. A tough catch. Having to turn, but Hunter right there to bat the ball out of Douglas's hands.
So Harris comes on to punt yet another time for California. He's driven the ball pretty well tonight. Williams will be the deep man. Rodney Williams can scoot. Cats with a 10-man front. Long count. They drop off and pull run back. Line drive kick. Williams says, let's get out of here. And the ball takes a bounce out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. That's where the Wildcats will start. We take it to the studios and Kevin Frazier for Game Break.
Guys, a shootout in Little Rock. Peyton Manning and the Tennessee Volunteers down, but not anymore. He hits Marcus Nash. 49 yards for the touchdown, but miss a two-point conversion. 23-22, Mr. Gore on top of Mr. Clinton.
Thank you very much, Kevin. The political battle raging.
I wonder if they have an elephant entertainment at halftime.
That's right. There's a reverse with Northcutt. Trying to get outside at the 35, at the 40, at the 45 midfield. Look out, at the 40, to the 30. One man to beat, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, Wildcats. Woo! 62 yards, and Rams, let's watch when we get the replay. The block by Keith Smith.
There were a couple great blocks. Keith Smith hands off to Trunk Candidate, who hands off to Dennis Northcutt, and watch the block on Johnny McLaughlin right there, just enough to spring Northcutt, and Northcutt getting around the edge again, and look at his speed right there. Boy, the sophomore out of Dorsey High School able to throw on the afterburners.
Big play, 62 yards, puts the Cats in front with the extra point, 14-7, 7:19 remaining, first half. We're coming back.
The drive for the playoffs is on with the NFL on Fox. First, division foes meet as Chris Carter and the Vikings try to hold off the Lions and Barry Sanders.
there. One of football's best rivalries takes center stage as Terry Allen and the Redskins go for the season sweep against Troy Aikman and the Cowboys. Fox NFL Sunday is stepping it up. Turn to your local Fox station for all the action. Noon Eastern, 9 Pacific.
Welcome back, ladies. I trust you had a great summer. Professor Casey Jones in the house. How did you spend your summer vacations, Miss Rosati?
I did drill after drill.
I had a picnic with some fans.
I pumped up for the season.
I relaxed with a game of golf.
Miss Steele?
I took a family trip, did a little modeling, got ready to kick rookie butt.
But now it's time for basketball season.
Portland meets Colorado, Sunday at 4 on Fox Sports West.
Please welcome today's guests, God and the Devil. God, big Clippers fan. Woo. Devil, goes without saying, Magic fan.
We love hoops. We even like to mix it up in purgatory now and then.
What's St. Peter, Evan? I get no calls just because I'm the Devil. Does that make me a bad guy?
Whoa, don't puke on my set, you freak.
Brent Barry and the Clippers invade the O to face Penny Hardaway and the Magic. Tuesday at 4:30 on Fox Sports West 2. Home teams, Fox attitude. You're watching Fox Sports West.
I don't think there's any question about that. Dick told me the staff saw something in the film. It's the third time they ran that play, and this was the big one, Rams.
Yeah, Trunk Candidate does a nice job of selling sweep, and then all of a sudden, Dennis Northcutt takes it the other way. He's able to set up the play remarkably, and what ends up making the play, once Keith Smith, watch him, he's going to hand the ball to Trunk Candidate. Northcutt comes around, but watch Keith Smith as he ties up John McLaughlin, number 33, the lead block, number 12, ties up number 33. McLaughlin enough, just enough to spring number 8, Dennis Northcutt, into the end zone.
Bears looking for the short kickoff, and they get it straight up in the air. Vera. Rivera was there with O'Neal, or rather with, let's see who that was that did get that ball. It was Serwina. And they almost ran into each other. So that short kickoff has really been working, not only for Arizona, but we've seen it work up and down this conference.
Yeah, these high marks, Adrian Koch, 52. Special teams player and a reserve linebacker there to make the hit as soon as the ball hits Saranga's hands.
So the Bears take over, trailing by 7 now at their own 30-yard line. Offense has sputtered since the first drive. And give this time to Tarik Smith, nothing. Stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Joe Tafoya makes the stop. Tafoya, redshirt freshman. Here are the rushing numbers for California so far. A 2.7 average. And remember, that includes a 41-yarder. So they really only have 2 yards beyond the 41-yarder by Tarik Smith. That's not going to get it done.
You check that shit out.
There is Joe Salabea, and that is not good news. There's a blitz coming. And Benner, no place to go. They brought Marcus Bell on the blitz from an inside backer spot, and Benner had nowhere to go. And again, the Bears go backwards. This is very reminiscent of Desert Swarm.
The Bears have been going backwards because that defense of Arizona, led by Rich Ellerson, they're fourth in the conference, and they continually take the aggressive stance and pound you and just come from all angles. Tafoya, 99, and Marcus Bell there. They're putting a lot of heat on the passer tonight.
Fourth sack of the night, and a whole lot of hurries. Is Benner in trouble again? Steps away this time, throws on a run, and it is intercepted but out of bounds. Rashid Johnson made the pick, but was out of bounds when he did. Kelvin Hunter was coming on a corner blitz that time, and again, Benner had to hurry the throw.
And Rashid Johnson out of Lincoln High in San Diego. Some great players have come out of Lincoln High in San Diego, not to mention Marcus Allen, Terrell Davis, Rashid Johnson. But you said it, Barry, they put the pressure on the quarterback and they lured him into bad throws.
So Harris will punt it away for California again. Williams back at the 31-yard line to receive it for Arizona. Ender Varenne's short kick. It's going to skip out of bounds right at about the 40-yard line. And that's where the Cats will take over. 37-yard punt, no return. We mentioned earlier, it's a chilly evening here. Temperatures are expected to drop into the 40s before this night is over. And again, a reminder that we will take you to our College Football Saturday studios with Kevin Frazier and Solomon Wilcots. They will tell you exactly how the Rose Bowl picture comes into focus. The Big Ten picture as well. Tennessee and Arkansas, as we've said, the Gore versus Clinton matchup. Keith Smith at quarterback now. He's got no place to go. He steps up and will run at the 40, 45, out of bounds to 47, a gain of 7. Keith Smith may be at his best when plays break down.
Without question, number 12 has the ability to make something happen when the play breaks down, and also having command of that offense, no need to huddle. Time to utilize the clock and get as many plays run as possible.
Keith Smith, of course, played a year of professional baseball, throws a quick one this time for Northcutt. Northcutt turns it upfield, gets out of bounds at about the 44-yard line of California. Right now, let's go to the sidelines quickly to Carol Lewis. Carol?
Thanks a lot, Barry. Just a quick comment on Joe Salavea. You saw him leave the field on crutches. They are going to take him underneath and have an x-ray. Right now, his ankle is being iced, and they hope he'll be back in the second half. Barry?
He is a tough guy, as we said. First down, Wildcats at the 44-yard line of California. Smith out of the shotgun, blitz comes. Smith steps up, no place to go, Matt Beck. Really unchecked. Somebody got just a little piece of him, but it wasn't gonna be enough. He telegraphed that blitz. And they brought Beck from the outside that time.
And Matt Beck, an impact player for that Cal defense. Of course, he's missed three games because of a bad shoulder, but watch him come by. He just eludes a block of Kelvin Ethan, and then he gets enough of a hit on Keith Smith to knock him down.
There's show blitz again. 10-man front shown by California. Now they back out of it. And they come with a blitz. And Smith airs it out deep. He's got Brennan out in front. He's got it at the 5-yard line, down to the 3. And a flag is down way back where Smith threw the football, but that may be roughing the passer. Hold, it's coming back.
Oh my, and it's a shame because Arizona had exactly what they wanted as the defense lined up.
And a perfect ball by Smith. It's interesting how Brennan is a guy who just runs good patterns. He's not the fastest guy by any stretch of the imagination, and yet he had a step. And it's all, I think, in how you run the patterns. Like in the UCLA game today, where Farmer, who's not the quickest guy on the Bruins, ran away from everybody. Somehow it just happens.
Yeah, and what happened ends up, they have, Keith Smith does a great job of, yeah, you look at Jose Portilla, he tackles Mawuko Tabeno. Just had his arms around number 58, Tabeno, and Keith Smith knew that he had thrown the right ball at the right time. More importantly, it was a great read by Keith Smith.
So Smith now will have to get it done from his own 34-yard line. It is second and 32. And whistles blow, and we're going to get a flag before the play here, I think. Ifon and Portilla are jawing at each other. And I think the reason is that Kelvin Ifon and Matt Beck were having words, and Portilla, being the good guy, stepped into the middle. And when he steps into the middle, you've been stepped into.
The gentle giant at 6'6 and about 330. I think I'd listen to Jose also.
Well, the Cats will go back 5 more, and it'll be second and 37. Four-man rush, Smith steps up. Now he throws, and incomplete, intended for Brennan, all wrapped up in the arms of one of the Bears, Derek Gardner. A lot of jawing going on down there.
Third and 37. Can you say quick kick?
There's one we haven't seen this year.
That's what I would do. gained back some field position. That penalty really drove Arizona far back, and it really takes them out of their offense. Keith Smith just trying to pick up a portion of that 37 yards.
Smith on the quarterback draw. 30-35. Gets the outside at the 40, at the 43-yard line. Still well short of the first down, but he does set up the punter pretty well here.
In the field position battle, he did himself a nice service here. He got up the field, made some positive yards, and you know you're asking for a lot trying to pick up 37, but if you can pick up a portion of it, give your punter a little better field position as Chris Pallett comes on to boot, so be it.
But he got 14. Delph O'Neill will be the deep man for California back at the 22-yard line. 7-point game, 14-7, Arizona over California. Pallett drives this one. O'Neill back to the 13-yard line is just crushed.
Kelly Malvo just came and stung him. What timing that was by Malvo, number 21, as he raced down on the punt team. Take a look, the star defensive back comes in and just gets a shot on O'Neill, and that's enough for Hunter to take him down. But this is, I tell you what, I credit O'Neill just for fielding the punt, number one. It was a great punt by Pallett.
44 yards, and the return took him backwards. So California again starts deep in its own territory. Out of the I formation to give the fullback this time, White. And White gets positive yardage across the 20 to about the 22, gains about 9. It'll be second and one. And I honestly can't remember the last time Cal had a second and short. Joshua White is a load, 5'11", 245 out of Honolulu, came to California from junior college, Snow Junior College in Utah, which produces a lot of Division I athletes. Here's the Bears' last four possessions, and that's flat ugly. Pitch this time to Tarik Smith, and he falls back the 20-yard line. So even when it's positive for California, it turns out negative.
Field, just the playing surface a little bit wet. Sometimes the players don't always have the right shoes on and the right cleats. Tarik Smith that time slipping. As you were saying about Tarik.
I was just going to say, he's now 9 for 40. Stein carries 47 yards, and that includes that 41-yarder. So that will give you an idea of how his evening has gone since the big gainer. Double slot this time. And Vetter rolling to his left. And he can run. He's got a little room for the 25-yard line. He'll have the first down.
And that was a designed run the whole way. Lead blocker out in front for Justin Vetter. He was able to pump fake and continue to move and pick up the first down.
So first down just short of the 25-yard line. Bears go out of the I formation. They bring Douglas to the near side and Shaw to the far side. Play fake. Vetter throws, caught by Douglas at the 35-yard line. That's going to be another Bear first down as Kelly Malvo makes the stop. We go to the studios. A game break with Kevin Frazier.
Guys, I know it's wacky, it's crazy, but let me try and help you out with this Pac-10 race. We've just heard from a Pac-10 official who says Washington officially out of the race, so that leaves Washington State, UCLA, and Arizona State. But none of them control their own destiny, Barry. We'll straighten it out for you in a few minutes.
Thank you very much, Kevin. And so we've now established that Washington is out. Actually, we do know how all this works, but I'm going to let Kevin explain it to you.
I believe Washington State can run the table, though. If they win, they won today, they win next week, they go, right?
No.
No. Okay. All right.
No.
If you I'll let Kevin figure that one out at halftime. And Solomon, you guys have fun with that.
You guys will do it, but that's not a gimme. Second down and 8. Split backs. Vetter will throw out of the backfield. O'Neill can't hang on.
Well, UCLA, by beating Washington as handily as they did today. They really impressed, I know, the two Pac-10 coaches today that we're talking with, Dick Tomey and Tom Homo. They couldn't believe it. They couldn't believe how well Washington was handled. And I mean, UCLA came out of the chute from the get-go, played great defense. Rocky Long, the defensive coordinator, had it dialed up. And again, they played him after a bye week, and I think that helps tremendously.
I think right now, today, though, UCLA and Arizona State are the two best teams in the Pac-10 Conference right now. Vetter throws, and Douglas can't hang on. Kelvin Hunter shadowing him. And the Bears, again, will have to give up the football. Douglas very upset with himself. He wanted that one. So Harris will punt for California. And Rodney Williams will stand back at about the 20-yard line. The Bears have just not had good field position and have been very inconsistent offensively.
Their starting positions on each drive, I guarantee, have not been favorable to them as well.
They're averaging at the 23-yard line. Their own 23. Harris gets a lot on this one. It's a high twisting kick. Fair catch. Williams at the 20-yard line. So the Wildcats will start at the 20-yard line, leading 14-7 and a minute and 38 seconds left in the half. Tonight's Academic All-American Profile is brought to you by GTE, and he is Arizona senior running back and wide receiver Kevin Schmidtke, playing his last game as a collegian here at Arizona Stadium, a 3-point GPA in political science. And he wants to be a dentist, a politically correct dentist, no doubt. There he is. I was trying to get him to talk, is like pulling teeth. Give this time to candidate. The candidate gets a couple to about the 23-yard line. I would have to think that Dick Tomey will play it rather conservatively here. Brandon Whiting makes the stop for the Bears.
I would imagine you could play conservative unless you spring a run right here, and then all of a sudden you get tossed into a quick offense. But with a minute left, they're pretty resigned to just running the football with two tight ends.
Colner, the backup quarterback, loosening up, but he was earlier too. And here's Candidate. Candidate almost got that run you were talking about. He's going to be stopped a little short, I believe, of the first down. Marquise Smith makes the tackle, and again, a lot of woofing going on, and a flag has been thrown at the 35-yard line. And let's see if the Bears continue to self-destruct here. It's against Arizona. So they will march this off.
And one of the things you find in a situation like this with a young team, it's how, if you keep your composure or not. And Tom Homo, he said his team, even though they've lost five in a row this year, he said his, and five of the last six, his team has come out week in and week out and practiced well and showed great spirits. And this is the time of the game where you know you have to play the end of the half, and then you have 30 more minutes to come back and give it your all.
Keith Smith is in at a wide receiver spot now on this third down and a whole bunch. And the give this time is to Kelvin Eaton, rather to Jay Hinton. And Hinton gets a little bit of room, but is stopped as he crosses the 25 at about the 26-yard line. And a late flag comes in again.
Jay Hinton's coming off a great game, too. 14 carries a week ago, 110 yards.
The Cats are going to be penalized again here, though, Rams.
Boy, a lot of personal fouls, too. And the referees don't mind dropping the flag. They want to keep the game clean. They don't want this kind of participation. And I believe, after this penalty's assessed, if the same player gets two personal fouls, he'll be ejected from the game, and then he'll miss part of the next week's game. So it becomes very crucial here who's getting all the flags thrown on him.
So the Wildcats will move backwards, and I believe it's going to be a post-possession penalty, which would mean it will be fourth down, if that's true. And now you would think the Bears would be stopping the clock here. They have two timeouts left. And they let about 3 seconds tick off the clock. Kelvin Ifon in a little heart-to-heart with the officials. Let's take a look at the scoring in the first quarter. They got it done quickly. Trump Candidate getting outside, and then it was just a simple foot race to the end zone. Candidate winning it. 28 yards, 7-0 with the conversion. Bears came back after a 41-yarder by Tarek Smith. Smith took it the final yard himself. Bears converted to make it 7-7. And then on the reverse this time, and a really well-played reverse as Northcutt goes 62 yards behind a great block by Smith and another good one right there by his wide receiver, Nadeau, and into the end zone for the score with the conversion, 14-7. That's where we stand, 12 ticks left.
And Arizona having one touchdown called back on a nice throw from Smith to Brennan, and the penalties are enormous for both teams.
Big story on the penalties. 6 for 82 yards for Arizona. 5 for 47 for California. That's not very pretty. 12 seconds left, and the Bears, if they can get any kind of a return here or a block, might possibly be able to do a little business. They come after it. And Delph O'Neill's going to handle it midfield and be dragged down immediately. Chuck Rich makes the stop. 37-yard punt, no return. And the Bears will have 4 seconds for a Hail Mary.
And they have the best field position of the day as they sit close to the 50-yard line. And if they had better use of the clock, you mentioned that, Barry, had they called a timeout, they could have saved themselves approximately 30 to 40 seconds on the clock.
Yeah, it was not really an expeditious use of the clock by the Bears, whose offense has gone absolutely dead in the water here. Better will just give on a handoff to Tarek Smith, and he will get to the 48-yard line. And with that, the first half will come to an end with a look at the scoreboard showing Arizona 14 and California 7. That's the way the first half ends. Right now, let's go to our College Football Saturday studios with Kevin Frazier. Kevin. Now, as night settles in here, the Arizona Wildcats settling in on the Cal Bears, leading 14-7. Barry Tompkins, Tom Ramsey, and Carol Lewis. California really kind of dead in the water. They're going to have to find something that really hasn't been there, Rams.
California with a West Coast offense needs to get untracked and head up the field. And I think their rushing game, Barry, has to be a big part of it. The Arizona defense, really, Rich Ellerson's doing a great job kind of plugging in players here and there and young players at that, but they're playing great run defense.
Looked like we were going to score a million points about 5 minutes into the game as each team scored on its first possession. Arizona got it done with Trunk Candidate. Just got outside, just won a foot race.
Trunk Candidate also is injured. We may not see him in the second half, but right there he goes steamrolling into the end zone.
California got a 41-yard run from Tarek Smith to set up this one. Smith from 1 yard out to make it 7-7. And then Dennis Northcutt on to reverse the third time they ran it. That was the charm.
Well, Dennis Northcutt, Arizona just looks for ways to get the ball into number 8's hands, and right there on the reverse, he's able to go the distance for the Cats.
And that made it 14-7. That's where we stand at the half. Whole bunch of different combinations we expect to see in the second half. Carol Lewis, just a moment ago, had an opportunity to chat with Arizona coach Dick Tomey. Here's Carol.
Well, Coach Tomey, first of all, I've got to ask about Joe Salovey and Daniel Greer. Are they going to be back in the game this half?
Well, we're not sure. It looks doubtful. It looks doubtful. They both, neither one of them can really do much that's weight-bearing right now.
And the quarterback situation, you're going back and forth. What does that look like?
Well, it just O.J. was a little wild, and Keith has legs that can really help us in certain situations. And with the kind of defenses they're playing, they're both good players. And so, you know, we've got three good quarterbacks, so we may do some more of the same.
Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
All right, that's Coach Dick Tomey, and he does have three quarterbacks now, as Brady Batten, who has been injured for several weeks and has had no minutes, if were to read between the lines, may give him a little time as well. He's more of a drop back guy, not quite as mobile as either Smith or Jenkins. But he actually was getting some time even when Keith Smith was the starter early in the year. There's that high short kick again, and it's going to be handled this time by Douglas, and Douglas will get the 35-yard line. That's actually working pretty well for the Arizona Wildcats. Take a look at the numbers at the end of the first half, Rams.
Well, the numbers, I think what's apparent is this number right here, the rushing yards, because it equates to the total yards. And without the ability to rush the football, Cal is limited. They can't rely on the arm solely of Justin Vedder. They're going to have to rush the football, and Arizona, with the piecemeal defense, has done a great job stuffing the run.
And 41 of those 53 yards, remember, came on one play. Out of the I formation to start things, and they give it to Tarik Smith, and he gets a few to about the 40-yard line. Gained about four. Joe Tafoya on the stop, and heard Dick Tomey tell Carol Lewis that it is not likely that we will see either Daniel Greer or Joe Salavea. Anthony Thomas has stepped in, and I thought done a very good job, and so too has Joe Tafoya. Second and six now for the Bears, and they give this time to the fullback, White. And White gets it up close to the 49-yard line. It's going to bring about a third down and a long two. Bears scored on their first possession, and after that, got very little business done.
And the average start drive, their own 28. So they never had great field position, although they were helped out with their last possession of the half right at the 48-yard line.
Third down, call it three. Smith trying to get outside, and Arizona's just too tough to run outside on. Stanford Glover runs him down, and the Bears will give it up. Arizona's philosophy, as a matter of fact, is to make you run outside. There is Joe Salavea. You saw him on crutches near the end of the first half. Now look at him. He's a tough hombre.
I can't believe he's just back out on the sideline, much less getting close to the field.
So Harris will punt it for California, and he's been one of the busiest guys on the field. They kick it away from Williams. Williams will let this go, and it's going to sail out of bounds right at the 10-yard line. That's a pretty good punt for Harris, an effective punt at any rate. 48 yards, and he got it out of bounds without a return. Good effort by Harris. So Arizona takes over. They too scored on their first possession, and the one play drive, you can hardly call it a drive, that on the reverse, and Northcutt taking it in from 62 yards out. Neither team really generating a lot offensively, but for that first drive. Keith Smith will get the call to quarterback to start things here in the second half. And you heard Dick Tomey tell Carol Lewis that Jenkins just a little bit out of control, only five completed passes. Smith had the long one down to the 1-yard line, but it was called back for a hold. And they'll give it this time to Candidate. Candidate taking some serious hits as he gets the 15-yard line. Again, a four. James Gibson makes the stop for the Bears.
And I think this is the opportunity for the Cal defense to resurrect itself. If it's going to have any impact in the next game and a half, the remainder of this game, and then leading into the big game at Stanford, they're going to have to stop Arizona and give their offensive opportunity to win this game.
Jenkins is now at quarterback. So they change on the fly here, like a hockey team. Jenkins rolls out, run all the way. 15, 20, 25, and out of bounds at the 30-yard line. That was just set up to be exactly that way. 15 yards on the pickup by Ortiz Jenkins.
And what Homer Smith asks of his quarterbacks, keep an eye on the defensive end all night long and tell me when he comes crashing down. And he did just that. Tabena was the one who crashed down, and then DeStefano has to come from his free safety position to finally put the handles on Ortiz Jenkins.
Sideline warning for California the next time they violate the sideline rule, which is to keep back, I believe it's 3 yards. Then there would be a penalty against the Bears bench. First down, right at the 30-yard line. Jenkins stays at quarterback. Play fake, he'll throw. Steps up, throws, got Williams wide open. And Williams goes down immediately at the 46-yard line. He was isolated one-on-one with Kato Sirwanga that time. was a nice ball thrown by Jenkins too, Rams.
It was a great throw. Watch Rodney Williams. He runs an out and a little shake up and then another out. And that's just a great one. It's a great play. Number two, great patience by Ortiz Jenkins and great arm strength, just allowing him to throw the ball on the numbers right there to Williams.
Saw the numbers on Williams, and now the Cats moving the ball at the 46-yard line on the first down. Candidate tries the short side, gets it close to midfield. Give a gain of four on first down.
And it's good to see Candidate back in the game. He was a little iffy at halftime. He had again hurt that ankle, and he's had it wrapped up several times. Numbers on Trunk Candidate tonight, and again, he's been one of the prominent runners in the Pac-10 all year long, but by missing three games, he really kind of falls out of the statistical categories. Although with that average, he will vault right back into the top rung of rushers in the Pac-10.
Here's an interesting set. A trips left, and they split the tight end Lucky to the near side. Now, oftentimes, teams will run out of this spread formation. Jenkins checking off here. Got 4 seconds to get the playoff. And he does. Blitz comes. Jenkins throws for Lucky. He had to unload the ball quicker than he wanted to.
They had the matchup they wanted, and Ortiz Jenkins probably went to the line of scrimmage with a check with me, one play or the other. He may have checked out of a run, just trying to spin the ball out to Mike Lucky. But actually, I think Cal had a good matchup. Marquise Smith, the strong safety, was lined up that time on Mike Lucky.
I like the way Dick Tomey described Jenkins to us. He said he's a guy who sort of takes the attitude, he's just going on down to the park, give me the ball and let me throw it.
And he's thrown it with great confidence.
I mean, trips left again. Jenkins to throw, look out! In the fumble, and it's picked up this time by Tubenio, and he's gonna go in for a California touchdown. And nobody saw Sanyika blow in, most particularly Jenkins. Big play for the Bears defense.
And I really believe that if Cal has any opportunity to win this game tonight, they have to have a couple more big plays by the defense. But Sekou Sanyika, number 13, comes from the right flank, the right edge, unblocked. And Jenkins feels him right at the end, but he's able to strip the ball out. The ball falls right into Mawuku Tabeno's hands, number 58. He does a great job strutting in the end zone.
He got there uncontested. And the extra point hits the crossbar, no good. Well, we talked about special teams, Rams, and it has not been a very pretty picture here. It remains a 14-13 ball game. Watch him go down right as he hits the ball.
Tim Wallach hits that slippery spot on the field, and he hits that right post.
14-13. We're coming back.
Why does she play field hockey? She knows there will be no shoe commercials, no trading cards, no limos. So why? Because she is an athlete. Just like a football player, just like a basketball player, just like a baseball player. GTE is proud to be the official telecommunications consultant to the NCAA and the Pac-10 because of her and the pure spirit of college athletics.
Weekends are for relaxing and spending time with family and friends. But for most homeowners, it's the only time to straighten out personal finances. That's why First Plus is open on the weekends, every weekend. We're available when you're at home thinking about consolidating bills or financing home improvements. Just call 1-800-510-PLUS. You can apply today right over the phone, and there's no application fees. First Plus takes care of business 7 days a week, just like you do. At First Plus, we're working first for you. Call 1-800-510-PLUS.
Just a second.
Look, you got the wrong guy.
Whoa. Boy, you're tall. Can I get you a beer? It's Sam Adams.
There are times when only a perfect glass of beer will do.
That's a good one, Grim.
Sam Adams, a better glass of beer.
Well, the Bears there's defense very happy. Maruko Tubenyo takes it into the end zone. You want a really scary number here, Rams? He's the fourth leading scorer on the Cal Bears this year.
Ouch.
Right here. Zanyika drives the ball out of Jenkins' hands right into Tabeno's hands. And Tabeno, 6'1", 230-pound sophomore, really has become a playmaker for that defense, and the coaching staff has been awfully happy with his play.
38 yards on the fumble return by Tabeno. That's his second touchdown of the year. He scored two more touchdowns than Justin Vedder. Chris McAllister is the defender to receive this kick. That, incidentally, was the seventh missed extra point that the Cal Bears have suffered through this year. There's an out-of-bounds kickoff. That's the third one of those we've seen tonight. Well, these two teams are struggling this year, to be sure, and we had a chance to chat with that man, Tom Homo, about the comparison.
I think the teams are very similar at this point. There's one game difference and one loss. Both teams have a lot of young players. Both teams have young players that are playing very big roles for their team. I think both teams have, I think maybe the coaches think that they're a little bit better than their records show, and they know that on any given day, these teams are going to come along, and it could be this week. We're hoping that this week is the week that Cal explodes.
Well, they've exploded on occasion, and they've imploded on a couple of occasions. Here's Smith stepping up. He's got room. He's the 40. He's the 45 and is crushed as he crosses the 45-yard line. Albert Dorsey with help from James Gibson. But he is quick.
Ooh, and I tell you, Albert Dorsey does not go for the swivel hip look either. Keith Smith, again, one of his strong points at the ball, if the pass receiver's not there, but watch Dorsey just put the hammer on him, and then Gibson from behind to finish him off.
Out of the shotgun, Smith again throws for Ifon out of the backfield. Ifon turns it upfield, gets to about the 48-yard line. That's only about back to the line of scrimmage, maybe gained a yard. Dorsey and Rhodes make the stop.
Dorsey very active right now, coming off the field, but he again got a hit on the ball carrier that time. And they need play out of that Mike linebacker position, that inside linebacker position next to Matt Beck.
Straight back goes Smith again, in trouble, steps up, gets away from it. Now he rolls right, now he'll run, and steps out of bounds at midfield. All of that for a gain of about a yard. It's going to be third down and about eight.
Well, what you're seeing right here is Cal playing some inspired defense. Keith Smith, last year versus Cal, 502 yards, total yards, set a freshman record. Watch his escapability. That's Carter, 73, who misses him. And then Smith again, able to get up the field. Wasdorf there to run him out of bounds.
Fact is, the Bears' defense has been very good the last 2 weeks. They played well against Arizona State last week in Berkeley. Smith straight back this time. Now he throws, comebacker, caught by Northcutt, I believe. If he gets a good spot, and he should. Well, he didn't get a very good spot. I thought he had the first down.
Well, actually, right when they put the ball down, though, Barry, the linesman, I believe he's going to give him the first. It's awfully close. He actually put it ahead of where he had placed his foot. Now the referee came over to hold the ball down on the ground, but he did have enough for the first down. Keith Smith really fired the ball out there. Watch where he goes out of bounds. He drags his foot. The upfield foot went out of bounds plenty for the first down, but it was the foot that came out late.
And it is going to be a first down. It does strike me that this Arizona offense, at least tonight, runs more efficiently with Keith Smith. Tonight.
I would agree with that, only because Keith Smith has had more time in the saddle. Ortiz Jenkins, having not fulfilled a lot of time through training camp as a quarterback, played a lot of receiver during training camp, and really they were set to go with Keith Smith and Brady Batten. And Batten, of course, separated his shoulder in the University of Alabama Birmingham game, and he has just since come back. But Keith Smith does have a very firm handle of this offense.
There's a blitz coming from the inside with Beck. They pick it up. Smith throws, got an open man, Brennan. Brennan tries to stay in bounds and does. And is dragged out of bounds the 21-yard line. Pete DiStefano stayed with him, but a big gain and a first down for the Wildcats.
Keith Smith hangs in the pocket, very patient, and watch Rodney Williams coming inside, and then Brennan just running a corner shake route, does a great job of staying in bounds. It almost eludes DeStefano.
So a first down at the 21-yard line. Smith, quick pitch rather than Northcutt, who steps out of bounds at about the 18-yard line. We're going to take you back to the studio now for a game break with Kevin Frazier. Kevin?
Guys, big day for UCLA as they roll over Washington. Big day for Skip Hicks. He has four TDs, and that makes him into some very elite company. He now owns the single-season touchdown mark for the Pac-10, also tied with Charles White for touchdowns in a career. I bet you he should get a vote for Player of the Year.
Yeah, but if Mauluka Tabenu gets 21 more. Toss to Brennan. Touchdown, Arizona. Effective drive led by Keith Smith.
Keith Smith did have a great handle on the offense that time. He's able to get the ball in the shotgun formation and just read the play from start to finish. The Cal defense really giving away a lot of territory that time. Strong safety came out, forced a free safety over the top to cover, and that created the touchdown.
Kick is good, but a flag is down. Why doesn't that surprise me?
Yeah, I was going to say, a flag? Oh, okay. At least it didn't happen on the touchdown.
Seven plays, 65 yards. It only took a minute and 19 seconds, and the 18-yard pass from Smith to Brennan. His penalty is going to be against California, so the extra point is going to be good.
Well, Keith Smith is a good quarterback, and he knows right
illegal
here.
Participation, 12 men on the defense. Penalties refused. Point's good.
What I want you to watch the strong safety blitz right now. What Keith Smith is going to read, he's going to read over the top coverage, but all of a sudden they come off of Brennan, and Pete DeStefano is thrown into coverage, and it's an easy read for Keith Smith. They leave the middle of the field wide open. Brennan snaps off his route over the middle. Good throw, good catch, touchdown Cats.
Brennan just makes the big catch. He's been doing that all year. Keith Smith, happy guy. It's been a long time between touchdown tosses for Keith.
I think a big portion of what makes Brennan able to get open, he understands how defenses play. And when you see blitz as a receiver, much less a quarterback, you know you're going to get the ball thrown to you. You know the quarterback's on a quicker time clock. He's looking to distribute the ball quickly. And if they clear the middle of the field for you, hallelujah.
Jenkins and Keith Smith very supportive of one another, and both of them are going to play somewhere. Here's that high short kick again. Serwanda handles it at the 30-yard line and stopped immediately. So it may not be pretty, but it has been effective for Arizona. Now we've got a little pushing and shoving and words, and it's starting to get a little ugly out there. The officials try to step in and maintain order.
And this is what you don't want to have happen, because when the penalties are handed out and they come down from the Pac-10 office on Monday, you don't want to miss your big game. You don't want to miss your rival game for a silly, stupid penalty as coming off the bench to fight.
And a flag is down. Just to remind you, we'll see what it is in just a moment. Tomorrow it's a Fox NFL Sunday doubleheader, and it all starts with America's most watched pregame show. And then don't miss a key NFC Central matchup when the Vikings take on the Lions. That's followed by the Redskins as they clash with the Cowboys. That and a whole lot of other regional action. Turn to your local Fox station for all the action at noon Eastern, 9 Pacific. Check your local listings for the game in your area. Arizona with all the offense in the second half, 93 yards of offense. And the Cal Bears with just 6. A lot of barking going on.
Dictomi down there with the assistant head coach, Dwayne Aquina. Doing a little barking.
Dead ball, personal foul. On the kicking team, be 15 yards, be first down.
Arizona called for the penalty, and we've been talking about how penalized California's been. Well, it's Arizona that's getting the big chunks of penalty yardage tonight. There's Dwayne Aquina. He's still pretty hot.
Yeah, Dwayne has been with Dick Thome for many years, and of course, Dick, it's amazing when you look at his coaching ledger. 10 years at Hawaii, winning as coach in Hawaii history, and then of course 10 years at Arizona here, the winningest coach in Arizona history. Dick Thome is, I think, one of the most interesting tales is he was on Homer Smith's Davidson University staff many years ago in 1964 prior to going over to Pepper Rogers' K-State staff, which Terry Donahue was on, Dick Thome, Carl Peterson, a lot of guys, a lot of football guys. And Dick Tomey's really lasted the test of time, and he's done a great job developing young men.
Homer fired him, didn't he?
Homer did fire him, and he had to hire him back because he couldn't hire anyone else.
They bring Shaw in motion on first down. Better to put it up. Comes back over the middle to Douglas. Douglas did a nice job just to hold on to the ball. Look at the swarming tackling by Arizona. Chris McAllister, incidentally, is playing out of control right now. He's going to have to cool down. He was in the middle of that last little set to, and he's still pretty hot.
Tempers run high because both these teams have a lot of pride, but what they have to do is settle back into their game plan, and they need to turn to their leaders to get settled in. Justin Vetter's going to have to talk to them in the huddle and say, look, guys, let's go out and just execute. And conversely, on defense, they need to settle down.
McAllister was about 15 yards out of that play and came running in just to jaw at Douglas. They're going to have to keep things cool here. Marcus Fields gets a gap, gets the 40 to the 35, taking people with him to the 31. David Phipp went for a ride. Gain of 18. Biggest gain on the ground for California since early in the first quarter.
And what makes the play up top is a great block by Damian Douglas on Chris McAllister. He gets tied up right there. McAllister just misses him completely. Phipp has to come up and somehow make the tackle, and Fields just drags him forward.
So the Bears suddenly moving to football at the 31-yard line. There's a blitz coming. They call a wide play against the blitz. Joshua White dragging bodies to the 15. Gain of 16, so they picked up 34 yards on the ground and two snaps.
Joshua White, 5'11", 245 pounds, Snow College, JC out of Utah. That was a nice find by Tommy Holmo, and watch him just push the pile, and he's got some big people. Kevin Swillis, 75, helping him out, and they just drove David Fitt back.
So the ball at the 17-yard line, and a first down for the Bears. Pitch to Marcus Fields, trying to get outside, not going to do it. Fields has run out hard. A trail of bodies. Chris McAllister gave him a big time shove. Chris McAllister right now still playing a little out of control. Might have gotten his bell rung on that too.
Chris McAllister, one of the top players not only in the conference but in the entire nation, and he may jump out early. He's looking at a possible long future in the NFL.
There's a blitz coming. It's picked up. Vetter throws underneath for Shaw. Shaw at the 10. Shaw to the 5. First down Bears inside the 5-yard line. Marcus Bell makes the saving tackle. The Bears, though, in business with a first and goal.
Right here, come back to Mr. Steady. Little play action, little fake into the line, and then it just frees up number 3, your playmaker, Bobby Shaw, and Shaw does such a great job of running through tacklers and getting the essential yardage.
First catch that he's made since the first pass of the ball game, I bet. First down and goal, Bears. Marcus Fields on a slant, slips and falls. Must be awfully slick in that portion of the field. That's right about where the kicker slipped in that last extra point.
Good point. The field's a little chewed up down there, and Marcus Fields, of course, the freshman out of Stagg High School in Stockton, he's going to get the true test tonight. Does he have the right length of cleat on? Because that's what you want to go out. You want to go out and assess the field in the pregame warm-ups, and you never want to slip if you're an athlete. You always want to have the proper shoes on.
So that divot that Fields picked up. Here's the fullback right again, stopped as he gets back to the line of scrimmage, and it's going to be third and goal from the 5-yard line. And again, tempers really flaring.
And that Arizona defense just comes at you in waves right here. Deshaun Pope makes a great job to free up Marcus Bell, who gets the first hit. And then David Phipp comes over and wrestles him down.
Guess who's back in the ballgame? Joe Salavelli.
Is it Halloween?
I tell you, he's tough.
Wow.
Third and goal Bears at the 5-yard line. They cover the blitz. Slant, touchdown. Caught that time by Bruce Pierre. And the Bears will likely go for two here.
Yeah, the coach is trying to redirect their players back onto the field.
Make sure your
Brian Surgener, tight end, coming back onto the field. Just a nice job. Three-step drop by Justin Vetter. Damian Douglas clears it out for Bruce Pierre, who lined up wide, and all it was a double slant. They beat him. They beat the corner, Kelly Malvo, that time for the six-pointer.
So they go for the two to tie it. They bring Shaw in the slot, Pierre to the far side, and Douglas to the near side. Now Shaw in motion, it's a reverse, a fake reverse, and a throw underneath for the two-point conversion to Vera. Well-executed play and a very different look. And we are tied at 21. May not be pretty, but it is exciting. 6:09 remaining, third quarter. Arizona 21, California 21.
I fell off my bike. I got hit by a baseball. I tripped over a rock.
Fox Sports has a long tradition of innovation. You can see that same spirit in every Fox Sports news show.
End up in that hot, hot zone.
Because our goal isn't to give you just a score, a highlight, or a stat.
It's about trying something new, something different.
It's to take you closer to the story than ever before.
Let me ask you about that third down call.
Got those with something low and away?
At least that's the plan.
I don't want to shake the guy guarding me. I want to own him. First I roll up on him, then back up on him. Do a reverse, fake him out. Then he'll freeze like a deer caught in the headlights. That's when I take my shot. Bam! Nothing but net.
The Kings wrap up the homestand when they face Chris Chelios and the Blackhawks. The puck drops Thursday at 7:30 on Fox Sports West. The Grizzlies meet the Lakers Sunday at 6:30 on Fox Sports West.
We're tied at 21, 6:09 remaining in the third quarter. Here's another look at the two-point try. Oh, I beg your pardon, this is the touchdown, a slant, and Pierre on the receiving end, and well executed, and so too was the two-point conversion attempt. Show you that in just a moment here, right after the kickoff. 8 plays, 52 yards, 3 minutes, 16 seconds. Better to Pierre on the 5-yard touchdown pass for the Bears, and the 2-point conversion ties it. Brashe to kick it off. Fairly short one also, drives McAllister to the 5-yard line. He's got a little room. He's the 30 at the 40. Cuts inside, gets the 45 to the 47-yard line. A big return by Chris McAllister. Now let's take a look at that two-point conversion. It looked like they had about 3 options here.
And what was great, all of a sudden you have the fullback coming underneath, and Vetter just picks him up and tosses in the ball. An easy one to Mark Vera in for the two-point score, but really the decoy was Bobby Shaw.
40-yard kick return by Chris McAllister, and Keith Smith brings his team to the 48-yard line to start things here. All of a sudden, offenses have got the wake-up call. Smith airs it out and throws it behind Kelvin Ephod, the intended receiver, Matt Beck, covering.
Great coverage that time by Matt Beck, running stride for stride with Kelvin Ephod. And that's what Matt Beck gives to this defense. He gives recognition defensively. He can call all the signals on the field and really the quarterback of that defense. And right there, showing his athleticism, running stride for stride with another great athlete.
So it'll be second and 10. The ball at the 48-yard line. Smith will put it up. They pick the blitz up. He throws for Ephod. Ephod out of the backfield. Midfield, 45-40. And Ephod giving as much as he's getting. He delivered a little bit on the sidelines that time to Chidi Uwoma. Gain of 11 and a first down. Here they gave Uwoma a pop.
Emotions starting to run high over there.
First down, short of the 40-yard line. Out of the shotgun again. Smith airing it out deep for Williams. And he can't catch up with it at about the 3-yard line. Kato Surwanga with the coverage for California. Pretty good coverage, too. Actually, Williams might have looked back for that ball a little bit early.
Yeah, I don't know if Williams picked up the ball right away in the air, because Kevin Smith really did it. Keith Smith did a nice job of getting the ball out in front of him. Just all he had to do really was put a little more air underneath it and let Williams run underneath it.
Nash and Brennan, the wide receivers, now on second and 10. Bears showing blitz, and now they come with it. Smith picks it up, throws to Brennan at the 35-yard line. Brennan took a hard shot but hung on. Derek Gardner with the tackle. Gains about 6. It'll be third down and 4.
And what happens? Keith Smith does a great job of holding up the count as the safeties were blitzing. What ends up happening, Brennan just runs a quick little turn route, and then Gardner comes up and hits him pretty well. Gardner may have hurt himself on the play.
Arizona goes with a no huddle here. Smith straight back with time. Now he steps up. He'll run. He's going to get the first down and more at the 30, trying to get outside the block of Brennan, and runs out of bounds the 28-yard line. Well, that's the element that Keith Smith can give you. Smith, the number 5 pick in the baseball draft of the Detroit Tigers back in 1994, did play a little baseball before coming to UA. Smith again throwing deep. He's got Ephon a little off. Matt Beck defending. Beck doing a pretty good job in coverage.
He really has. He drew the pass interference call one time in the first half, but since then he's been staying stride for stride with Kelvin Ephon. Right there, Homer Smith and Keith Smith trying to work a little magic, trying to free that running back up on the linebacker, but good coverage by Matt Beck.
See the numbers on Keith Smith. They go without a huddle again. Again, the Bears show blitz from the safety position. Now they back out of it. Smith throws for the end zone. Got North cut. Touchdown, Wildcats. And a late flag comes in, and I'm sure that's going to be one of those absurd, excessive celebration penalties.
I like how you put that, Gary, because
this is college football, the last time I checked. And, you know, emotion and excitement, that's part of the game. The band's playing, cheerleaders jumping up and down. Dennis Northcutt beats Chidi Uwoma, runs right by him. And Keith Smith just delivers the ball on time, a quick little three-step drop, and he fires the ball to Northcutt. Good for the touchdown.
Well, that is the penalty, and it is just awful. I can see it, to tell you the truth, Rams, if it really involves taunting and, you know, putting a ball in somebody's face.
Precisely. If there's taunting, I disagree with it. It should be a penalty. But to jump up and down and to, you know, have a fun time scoring a touchdown,
This is America. And it affects the outcome of the game, too. It could. They make the extra point from 35 yards out. Now, interestingly enough, that extra point was longer than any field goal that Arizona's kicked all year. Goose brain.
Protected your face all night. Why stop in the locker room? The Norelco Reflex Action Razor. Anything closer could be too close for comfort.
Mom's calling Enterprise Rent-A-Car because our car is sick.
Enterprise will arrange to pick you up.
Wow!
Drive you to our place and get you on your way.
Everybody loves to be picked up.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
It captured our imagination.
If it's not human, what is it?
And became a phenomenon. David Duchovny, Gillian Anderson, The X-Files, weeknights at 8, 7 Central, only on FX.
College football gets hot on Fox Sports Net. Southern Miss is poised to become king of Conference USA as they look to crush another opponent.
And down they go to the 20-yard line.
Southern Miss Memphis, next Saturday at 12:30 on Fox Sports West. Hardcore football gets down with Gilbert Brown. Don't miss the Packers' preeminent run stopper as he tells us what it'll take for the Super Bowl champions to repeat. Tuesday at 8 on Fox Sports West.
Seven plays, 52 yards, 28-yard score. Smith to Northcutt. Let's take a look at it, Rams.
Well, Dennis Northcutt just beats his man, Chidi Awoma. He runs by, and Keith Smith's going to deliver the ball. End result, touchdown. But Chidi Awoma never gets his eyes around and sees the ball. Northcutt just springs right by him. Great throw, great catch. Touchdown, Wildcats.
And Smith took a pretty good hit on the play as well. He really hung in there. There's Northcutt, his second touchdown.
Good job, Brad.
Run the ball for 60 yards. And caught four passes for 49.
And Keith Smith on the horn right there with Homer Smith, who's up in the press box.
There's that short high kick again. It's been very effective for Arizona. And it's Damian Douglas. This time gets a step. He's the 40 and thrown forward, flagged out. From the other side of the field, a flag behind the play. Tuesday on Fox Sports Net. Don't miss a behind-the-scenes look inside the NFL on NFL Total Access. That's followed by Hardcore Football with featured guests Kevin Butler, Trevor Maddich, Leslie Shepard, and Gilbert Brown. It's NFL coverage like no other network. That's NFL Total Access and Hardcore Football. Tuesday on Fox Sports Net. Check your local listings for the time in your area.
10 yards from the spot of the foul. First down.
Illegal block and 10 yards marched off against the Bears. So even when they do get a return off that short kick, it goes backward.
Well, I can't imagine how frustrated Cal feels constantly with any time they have any kind of a gain or momentum. And special teams has really been the culprit. The flags come flying out. You see right there, 74 yards against Cal, 113 against Arizona.
It's a lot of penalties. They bring Sean Motion on first down. And we're going to get a procedure called against California. The right side of the line moved prior to the snap.
And what's interesting, going back to those penalties, Arizona's the least penalized team in the conference, and Cal, of course, the most penalized team.
Dead ball, prior to snap, false start, on the offense, 5 yards.
So California again puts itself in a hole immediately, and that's been the story of Tom Homo's season. A lot of frustration showing on the face of Tommy Homo.
Tommy's been around some of the best coaches in America, though. Of course, from BYU, played under Lavelle Edwards, worked under George Seifert, Bill Walsh. Some of the great ones.
Better throws caught by Douglas. Douglas gets forward to about the 28-yard line, gets it back to the original line of scrimmage. It'll be second and 10.
And I think one of the things that makes it difficult for Cal, since this senior class of Cal has had three head coaches. And it's difficult. Keith Gilbertson, Steve Mariucci, now Tom Holmoe. It becomes difficult because, as Doug Cosby said, the offensive coordinator, they have a different dad every year.
And a different kind of dad, too. Three distinct personalities in those three coaches. There's a short side pitch this time to Fields, and he is stopped short of the 30-yard line. And it's going to be third down and 8. Rashid Johnson stopping Fields.
And you get a little more quality assurance with a guy like Tommy Holmoe, who's very settled in, understands the game, both offensively and defensively, played professionally, has a great understanding of how a championship team needs to look, and he's developing that young talent, and they're doing great on the recruiting trail as well.
Yeah, I really believe he's gonna get the job done at Cal. Straight back, Justin Better, now he rolls to his left, looking for some place to go, and the only place to go is out of bounds. Deshaun Polk chasing him.
And his hope for getting the job done at Cal is getting the job done on third down. That's where Cal has to be better this evening.
Well, I hasten to remind that Bruce Snyder was 3-8 in his first year at Arizona State before getting all his own players in there and turning things completely. And it is a potential powerhouse now at Arizona State. I think they'll be better next year than they are this year, and I think they're very good this year. There's a twisting kick headed for Williams. Makes a fair catch at the 37-yard line. Oh, we've got more college football coming up next Saturday. Southern Miss will travel to Memphis to take on the Tigers. Tulane will go to Houston to battle the Houston Cougars. That's all next week on Fox Sports Nets. College football Saturday. Check your local listings. 39-yard putt, fair catch, though no return. And now the Wildcats will try to put a little distance between themselves and the Cal Bears. Keith Smith remains the quarterback. They go to the slot left, three wideouts. Smith will go up on first down. Throws, and Northcutt can't quite hang on. He had a lunge for the ball a little bit.
Smith really having to unload the ball in a hurry. And yes, if he could have waited just a split second more, could have delivered the ball on time to Dennis Northcutt, who tried his best to come down with it.
Delph O'Neill, incidentally, is playing quarterback for California right now. I'll tell you a little bit more about that in a minute. Smith rolls to his right, buying time. Now he'll run. He's got room, 40, 45, midfield. 45, 40, and out of bounds the 39-yard line. Marquise Smith makes the tackle, but Keith Smith is just able to do that. 23 yards. He's a game breaker.
Boy, is he the energizer or what? I said in the beginning of the year, he's one of the most exciting players in the Pac-10, and just for this very reason. His escapability and all of a sudden the ability to be a game breaker. As you said, Barry, he's able to get up the field, jump over players, make big plays, and that's what it takes to play quarterback in the Pac-10.
Out of the shotgun again, a handoff to Hinton, and Hinton gets to about the 37-yard line. He got about three.
Talking about quarterbacks in the Pac-10, too, I have to say this because, one, I'm proud to be working in the conference, but when you have three of the top five throwers in the nation, Heward, Leaf, and McNown, and then you have players like Ortiz Jenkins and Keith Smith and Justin Vetter, boy, it just gives a lot of credibility to the conference.
176 yards of offense for this man. He throws, he's got Brennan. Perfect pass, and Brennan is down at the 18-yard line with a Wildcat first down. Now the other thing too, I think both offensive coordinators have made some excellent adjustments here, and what they're doing right now is they're really isolating the Cal safeties and they're burning them.
Precisely. They went in at halftime, and credit Arizona for really dialing up the situations that they're facing on long downs and distances, and they're achieving their goal.
There's a draw play with Hinton at the 15 at the 10-yard line. And he's going to be close to a first down. Marquise Smith makes the tackle, but right now, Wildcats picking it up in chunks. Second lead by 73, Andre Sanders.
Well, Delph O'Neal playing corner for California. He came in as a guy who could be either a running back or a cornerback. Really recruited, according to Tom Homo, as a cornerback, and very likely that will be his position next year. And he's out there right now kind of taking a trial run. He's also one-on-one with Northcutt. They go to Northcutt, and I think that time just a little mix-up between Smith and Northcutt. Northcutt cut it inside. Smith thought he was going to run a fade route. Smith said, my fault. So it'll be third down, a yard.
Yeah, they almost went without a huddle that time. And third and a yard, you really want to get in the huddle and dial up a good play. And that's exactly what they're doing now. You'd think they'd keep the ball on the ground. Miles and Ethan in the back in the backfield.
And the Bears have to burn a timeout. And that's the kind of thing that you hate to see in a close game. But they didn't have any choice. I guess they just didn't have the right bodies on the field. And so they will take a timeout with a minute and 17 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Tomorrow it's a Fox NFL Sunday doubleheader, and it all starts with America's most watched pregame show. And don't miss a key NFC Central matchup. It'll be the Vikings and the Lions. That's followed by the Redskins and the Cowboys, plus other regional action. Turn to your local Fox station for all the action at noon Eastern, 9 Pacific. Check your local listings for the game in your area. Well, Mickey Mouse is keeping the good folks here at Arizona Stadium warm on a chilly night. Temperatures down in the 40s, not unusual in the desert for this time of year. Pretty shocking, though, from the first time we were here, and it was, what, about 140, wasn't it? Arizona now starting to run away and hide in the offensive department from California. Look at 198 yards in the third quarter so far.
And Cal, one of those scores. Of course, their defense, DeBeno, scoring on the big second half fumble recovery and getting into the end zone. And then, of course, them getting another touchdown to Pierre and the two-point conversion, getting 21 points. But Arizona really showing the dominance again on the offensive line. Their offensive line really taking control of the game once again.
So Arizona with a third down and one. They have Miles and Ephon in the ball game. Two tight ends. And they give it this time to Ephon, and he's going to be close. I don't think he's going to get there. Now, Dick Tomey has a decision here. Now, you know, conventional wisdom would say you kick the field goal, but field goals have been an adventure for this team. And we'll kick it.
I think what he realizes right now, points are very important, and ordinarily he'd probably feel pretty comfortable going on fourth down. They succeed on fourth down at about a 58% clip. So he feels good about that, but points right now are very important as he approaches the fourth quarter.
27-yard effort for McDonald. And it is good. So McDonald knocks it through from 27, and the Wildcats have stretched their lead to 10. Seconds remaining in the third quarter, and the Arizona Wildcats have pushed it to a 31-21 lead over the Cal Bears. Dick Tomey likes what he sees. Senior day here at Arizona Stadium, and at halftime they introduced the senior members of the band. I haven't seen that before.
I wonder if Salavea got introduced over there too. He's probably like Gratis everywhere at senior day because he's already been through it once, so why not?
That's right.
Why not be introduced several times?
That's the first field goal for McDonald in five games. Last kick one against San Diego State. And again, I have to say that it is very uncharacteristic of an Arizona football team to have special teams problems. That has always been one of the hallmarks of a Dick Tomey team.
Yeah, they're also last in net punting, and that's a big, big area of concern for Dick Tomey as well. That means field position.
So again, the kickoff, and again, a short, high kick, and it's been successful. That's gonna, you might have to buy a ticket to get that one. So they'll place that at the 35-yard line. Again, we have a flag.
I think it's only the flag for the ball going out of bounds. I don't think there was anything
free
else
kick
dropped.
Out of bounds. Penalty's accepted. Ball be placed on a 35.
Although I saw a little ruckus down there that might have drawn another one, but I think the referees let that one slide. Thankfully.
Well, we do want you to know that this copyrighted telecast presented by the authority of the University of Arizona, the Pac-10 Conference, intended solely for the private non-commercial use of our audience, may not be rebroadcast in any form without the express written consent of Arizona, the Pac-10 Conference. I have no idea who carried that ball, but I believe it was one of the Bears running backs. I can't read disclaimers and watch the game at the same time. Joshua White was the ball carrier, and he picked up four.
I'm sorry, I just didn't get that third word in that disclaimer. I'm wondering if you could.
I'm going to read those backwards. See if anybody notices.
Well, I'm just kidding.
Third quarter has come to an end. And it was a very good third quarter for the Arizona Wildcats. 31-21, offense is starting to take over in this ball game, but Arizona is being a little bit more sufficient than the offense of the Cal Bears. The Wildcats lead it by 10, 15 minutes of football left, and we're coming back. A lot of points all of a sudden in the third quarter as we start the final period. And once again, California is in search of something that has only been there sporadically.
And Cal has to get something on the board quickly, being two scores down. They have to generate some offense. And this game will always go down to the wire. Both head coaches know that. Right from the get-go, Justin Vetter again over center calling signals. And guess what? Another penalty.
There's an upset. Arizona's now rushed the football for 218 yards. The Bears have managed 90 yards, and the bulk of those really came on three plays. They had 34 yards on two rushes by Fields and White.
Dead ball, ball start on the offense, 5 yards.
And 41 yards early in the ball game on the run by Tarik Smith. So it'll be second down and 11. The ball at the 34-yard line. Tarik Smith, the tailback. And now Shaw in motion to the far side. Better pitch this time to Tarik Smith. Nothing doing. Lost about two. Chris McAllister coming up, played the force from the corner.
Tell you who makes a play on this. Chris McAllister, watching from his corner position. He's going to come up and force and then make the hit and the tackle on Tarik Smith as he comes out. Chris McAllister does a great job shedding the blocker and then tackling Smith for the loss.
Three wideouts now for the Bears as Kofi Nardi goes to the far side. They bring Douglas in the slot. Better to go up in trouble. And he is wrapped up and dropped by Anthony Thomas, who's having an excellent ball game. They call Anthony Thomas the train, and the train was coming that time.
Pasadena High School, Anthony Thomas, a true freshman, just comes in and makes a big hit and a tackle. Vetter with no opportunity to get the ball down the field, and you watch as Thomas lined up his nose tackle, beat Jeremy Newberry, and came right through for the hit.
So again, Harris will come on to punt, and now Chris McAllister says we'll take a timeout. McAllister counting bodies here, and I don't know how many he counted, but my guess is it wasn't 11. We'll jump away, 13-40 remaining in the ball game. Arizona leads it by 10.
Serve your friends and family up a great time at the 1997 NCAA Division I Women's Volleyball Championship. December 18, catch the national semifinals. December 20th, see the national finals. Spokane Arena is the place to be. For tickets, call 800-325-SEAT. That's 800-325-7328. Don't miss your chance to see a national champion crowned.
Where once these ancient nameplates ruled, now each of them succumbs. For paradigms doth shift when something wicked this way comes. Introducing an automobile that outperforms the competition everywhere, including the bottom line, the faster, sleeker, meaner GS. See it now at your Southern California Lexus dealer.
Who's the big man that slams the world with just one hand? You're damn
acting
right.
Is being.
Can't quite put my finger on it. Something just ain't right.
Jack puts up the shot and it's...
That's what I've been missing.
Don't even think about it.
Pepsi. Generation Next.
Please?
Nah.
To you by GTE, the official telecommunications consultant to the NCAA, and by Burger King, where you can get your burgers worth. Well, Harris has gotten his burgers worth tonight. He's been out there a lot, and he's had it his way.
And he can run a fake if need be.
He has done that. Did it the first game, did it against Oklahoma.
Although fourth and 21, I know he's kicked.
Yeah, not likely that he'd be running a fake now. And he hits that one off the side of his foot. Williams runs up, handles the 35-yard line. It's a block from Malvo, still has no place to go, and is dropped at the 43. Well, a reminder, our final Pac-10 game of the year will pit these same Arizona Wildcats as they get it on with their upstate rivals, the Arizona State Sun Devils. And as Kevin Frazier and Solomon Wilcox broke down for you at halftime, the game could possibly decide the race for the Rose Bowl. Fox Sports Net will have all the action. It's on Friday, November 28th at 6:30 p.m. Eastern time.
Boy, it's been a while since all the interstate rival games have really meant a lot, and so many teams are involved with the Rose Bowl race.
The draw play to Candidate. The Candidate gets the 45, still on his feet, pops it outside midfield, and he's stopped by the last man as he got down to the 42-yard line, and Derek Gardner saved a touchdown.
Boy, didn't he rack his head making the tackle. Also, Trunk Candidate, watch him as he just springs right here. He keeps his legs driving, gets his shoulders at the field, then Gardner comes in and lowers the boom on him, but Kennedy doing a great job getting up the field.
Brandon Whiting got all turned around on that play. Here's a quick hitch to Northcutt. Northcutt at the 40 and steps out of bounds at the 38-yard line.
Well, I think Northcutt, with the emergence of Northcutt this year and Jeremy McDaniel coming back next year, they're going to have two receivers that are just very good. And then, of course, Brennan's only a sophomore. They lose Rodney Williams, but it's a great group of receivers.
Yeah, they're high on Brandon Nash, too, as another freshman. Here's Ifon, and Ifon is stopped by Sanika. Dick Tomey, his team has done an extremely good job offensively and defensively in the fourth quarter. In Tomey's defense, he has been banged up. His team has been banged up right from the get-go. They lost that game, our first game, on a Thursday night early in September, and they never really seemed to bounce back from that loss. And it was a very winnable game for them. Smith throws, and Brennan can't hang on. Smith had to unload the ball as Cal was coming on a blitz. Matt Beck putting pressure on.
Barry, you mentioned that game that on Thursday night, the opening game, as they're in two down territory here, and they will go for it on fourth down, but they weren't able to make the adjustments that first game of the season against Oregon, and they lost that game. Tonight, they were able to go in at halftime, redraw some plays, and get to the things that were productive for them in the second half. And right here, again, they're driving the football, controlling the clock, and lining up for a crucial fourth down.
They bring Northcutt in motion. Now they turn him around, bring him the other way. He finds a lone setback. They roll Smith. He throws, and is it really going to flag? No. break right there. Gardner draped around Northcutt.
Well, the Bears have not caught a lot of breaks, but as I was talking to Doug Cosby, actually the ball is just not well thrown, and I don't think Smith knew exactly where Northcutt was going, but I was speaking to Doug Cosby before the game, and he says, you know, good teams create good plays. And I couldn't agree more with that assessment, is that when you're not getting the bounce of the ball, you have to put forth the effort to make things happen, and you got to have 11 guys hitting on the same cylinder.
I actually think the interference that I saw, too, was away from the ball. Marquise Smith looked to me like he had a handful of shoulder pad. Play fake. Better will throw on first down. Got a man wide open this time is the tight end Surgener, and he gets it right to midfield for a first down for the Bears.
And you have to remember what a great job a year ago Cal did. Pat Barnes, of course, the quarterback, as Douglas ran off his man Malvo and created the room for Surgener. But you got to remember, Tony Gonzalez was a first-round draft pick as a tight end a year ago, and he caught a lot of balls.
Give this time to Smith, and Smith falls forward to about the 47-yard line. Anthony Thomas just caught him with a shoestring tackle. Smith fell forward for about three. Vera comes into the ballgame for California. They use him as a receiver quite often.
And Vera caught five balls a week ago versus Arizona State. That, of course, happened while Joshua White was out on a game misconduct penalty.
Better to throw. A throw for Vera. Vera makes the catch and is just popped immediately right at the line of scrimmage by Rashid Johnson. Nice play by Johnson.
Rashid Johnson just leads by example. He can play corner, and he probably will play corner in the NFL ranks. He's got great speed. He's a perimeter player. And you see what happens. Again, I think Arizona just has much better team speed than Cal, and Cal freely admits it. They don't have guys who are track athletes out there. Arizona does.
Third down and seven. Better short drop. Throw caught by Douglas. First down, Bears. Nothing fancy, but a good toss and a good catch from Better to Douglas.
And Douglas gave him a really nice target to throw to. A nice picture for Justin Better just to spin the ball into Douglas, and he did just that. They really have to be conscious of the clock now as they continue to move the chains.
Eight catches, 71 yards for Douglas. They give this time to Joshua White, who gets the 35-yard line, again, three.
And we haven't heard much from Bobby Shaw. Again, he only has two catches tonight. And I think now's the time you come back to your bread and butter. I think now you get the ball to number three, put the ball in his hands, and let him create some plays. He does such a great job of running through tacklers. Right now, a second and seven. Find number three.
Better straight back again. Going deep for Douglas. Well covered by Malvo. Did he get it? Yes, great catch by Douglas. Malvo could do nothing more than he did.
And the choice of Cal right now is go opposite Chris McAllister, continue to work on number 21, Kelly Malvo. And Malvo, the senior, being taken this time. D1 Douglas making a great catch. Going up the field, watch him. He just runs a fade, and the ball is throwing perfectly. Again, just a little tiny fake into the line. You don't need much, but all of a sudden, Malvo in the chase position. Douglas with a great catch.
And the Bears with the first and goal. And they give it this time to Smith, and he's in. Touchdown, Bears. Starting to be a pretty typical Arizona-California football game, isn't it?
Yeah. Don't get up. Don't get up and go to the refrigerator. Stay right here. Take a look. They're in a loaded backfield. Two fullbacks, great blocks, and Tarik Smith able to read the blocks great, make a nice little cut and get into the end zone for the score.
And now, one of the great adventures in college football, the extra point try. Bears missed one earlier, they missed seven this year. And that one is good. And it is a three-point game with 9 minutes, 36 seconds left to play. The Bears have cut the Arizona lead to three. The Wildcats 31, the Golden Bears 28.
Among America's great universities, only one takes 95% of its freshmen from their high school top 10%, offers the most top-ranked graduate programs, and manages to keep tuition under $5,000 a year. Of the 10 best universities in America, only one is a public university. The University of California, Berkeley, keeping the promise of public education.
You love the sounds. You want the hits. You need the game. Fox Sports Net has it all.
Oh, wow.
From the slap shots to the hot shots.
A magnificent goal!
It's the NHL's coolest players in the season's hottest matchups. You love the game. Too much to miss it.
Oh, what a beauty!
Fox Sports Net. Home teams, Fox attitude. The drive for the playoffs is on with the NFL on Fox. First, division foes meet as Chris Carter and the Vikings try to hold off the Lions and Barry Sanders. Then, one of football's best rivalries takes center stage as Terry Allen and the Redskins go for the season sweep against Troy Aikman and the Cowboys. Fox NFL Sunday is stepping it up. Turn to your local Fox station for all the action. Noon Eastern, 9 Pacific. The Blackhawks and Kings meet Thursday at 7:30 on Fox Sports West.
Well, Tarik Smith has put the Bears within three, 31-28. Seven plays, 64-yard drive, culminated by the 4-yard run by that man. That's a three-point game.
Right back into your standard Arizona-Cal game. Possibility of overtime looming. What would it be without a little overtime?
We haven't had one this year.
We've been close.
And a quick kick this. And McAllister will have a chance from the 7-yard line. That's the 15, steps outside, and is stopped as he crossed the 25-yard line by Damian Douglas, who made the big catch. Let's go back to the studio right now and Kevin Frazier for a game break.
Guys, today, the end of an era. The final home game of Eddie Robinson's 55-year run at Grambling. 37-35, the Tigers lose to North Carolina State, but the real tragedy here, less than 1,000 folks on hand at the game. In 2 weeks at the Bayou Classic, the winningest coach in college football history will coach his final game.
That really is a tragedy. He's one of the great men in college football. I had a chance to spend a couple days with him last year, and one of a kind. Talking to a piece of history. Keith Smith throws wide open. Northcott, first down, or close to it. Might not have made the first down. At the 36-yard line, Kato Sirwanga defending, and here's what the Cats have done the last four times, and they've been very productive.
Productivity in the second half goes to show you how important halftime is, and a little re-gauging and realignment of some people, and just really knowing what you can and can't get done and what the defense has given you. And I think once again, Arizona's team speed is the omnipresent force for the Wildcats. It just is a, you know, you can't coach it, and it's something that's just going to happen, and Cal just has to go out on the recruiting trail and find faster people.
Well, I think it probably started with Bobby Bowden was the first guy to just go out and recruit speed. And he said, I'll find a position for him. And I can remember being up in Seattle when Don James got that message after being blown up by Alabama in the Sun Bowl game. And he said the same thing. I'm just going to go out and recruit speed. And he did, and they, of course, have had one of the most, if not the most, successful program in the Pac-10 Conference over the last decade or so. Arizona, both schools in Arizona have always recruited speed. UCLA now is a very quick football team. The Oregon schools have always had good skilled people, quick. Keith Smith now 13 of 22, 144 yards and two touchdowns. Very effective game for him. Second down inches. Kind of a free play for Keith Smith there. And Smith just sneaks for it and gets the first down easily. Just picked a hole and ran to it. And let's go to the sidelines. Carol Lewis. Carol, what's doing down here?
Well, actually, it's getting really cold down here. And in Derek Gardner, number 31, the corner, every time he comes off the field between series, he's getting stretching out. They're massaging his legs, and obviously he's cramping up a little bit. But I talked to the trainer, and he said that's just regular maintenance, so they're not letting anything blow away. Barry?
Thanks, Carol. Stay warm. It is getting chilly.
Oh, this is T-shirt weather.
Yeah. The shotgun on first down, the ball up the 39-yard line. Here comes the blitz. They pick it up. Smith throws. He's got Brennan, and there's a flag. There's about eight flags. That may be the Pac-10 record for flags on one play. Chidi Uwoma just rode Brennan to the ground. And we have one, two, three, four flags. And I'm sure they are all for the same penalty.
What Keith Smith sees is that the free safety's coming in, locked up. All of a sudden, he's got Brennan again running down the field.
Take a look. 15 yards from the previous spot. First down.
All of a sudden, Smith fires the ball down the field. Chidi Uwoma coming through the back of Brennan draws four flags.
Four flags came from four different places. So they'll mark it at the 46-yard line of California. Kevin Schmidtke in the ballgame for the first time at a running back spot for the Wildcats. And he gets the call, and Schmidtke gets a gap and gets inside the 40 to about the 37. And a nine, it'll be second in the yard.
As Carol Lewis mentioned a moment ago, it is cold down on that field, and Kevin Schmidtke, who comes in as a senior, and what he has to do, he's got to stay warm the entire game. And I tell you, it's awfully tough for a running back or a quarterback or a wide receiver to stay loose throughout the game, knowing you might get a little action, and all of a sudden you got to be in the fourth quarter and be up to full speed.
Local product out of Tucson's Mountain View High School. Got a brother, Gabe, playing up at Oregon State. Schmidtke again with a gap again. And a first down inside the 30-yard line. Gain of seven for Schmidtke. Marquise Smith makes the tackle for the Bears.
And what Arizona's doing right now, they were lining up in their two tight end, two wide out, with Schmidtke as the power back. And Keith Smith is really starting to utilize the clock to his favor. He's watching the 25-second clock. He's winding it down. This is where Arizona really is fully aware of game management and clock management in order to milk off as much time as possible before they snap the ball into play.
They go out of the shotgun once again. And they give on a draw to a candidate, and candidate will get it down about the 27-yard line. You know, the thing that does strike me too, well, I'll tell you about it after we take a look at the Burger King game summary. 257 yards for California, but look at this. Arizona now approaching 500 yards of offense. A lot of offense in the third quarter. And we mentioned this earlier, the last 10 games in this series have been decided by seven or fewer points. We stand right now at a three-point differential. What I started to say is that we have not called the names of the down linemen for California very much tonight at all. Brandon Whiting, have not called Andre Carter's name all night. And Gibson on a couple plays, which, if memory serves, mostly were downfield. They give it to Schmidtke on a slant. Schmidtke inside the 20. That'll be a first down.
Yeah, the offensive line again of Arizona, Yusuf Scott and Jose Portillo, there to push the line of scrimmage, allowing Smithke to get up on that slant run and just really stretch the defense once again. And they're dominating the line of scrimmage. And it shows not only on the scoreboard, but on all the statistics. And it's interesting because Cal came in averaging 400 yards, and the Arizona defense has done a great job shutting that Cal offense down as well.
Yeah, they really have. And the strength of California's defense was the down line, and they're getting pushed around. Give it to Schmidtke again on a slant. Schmidtke gets to about the 15-yard line, maybe a little short of the 15. Schmidtke being a workhorse on this drive and getting the job done.
And the offense is very methodical, knocking off yardage as they knock off time off the clock and really into the ball control facet of their game. Take a look, when you average over 6 yards a carry, I tell you what, you're not only controlling the clock and the line of scrimmage, but the scoreboard as well.
Schmidtke, 4 carries, 27 yards on this series. Now they go out of the I formation with Kelvin Efon, and Smith's checking off here. They give it to Efon, and Efon gets inside the 15, about the 13-yard line. It'll bring about a third down and about three. Third and four. Andre Carter made the tackle. Now Carter comes out of the ball game, and the Bears bring in an extra defensive back. It's cold. Not your usual Arizona weather, although, as you said, this is not uncharacteristic for this time of year. A good sense to bring the blankets. Arizona now 507 yards. That's their most productive offense this year, and we will take a timeout. Arizona calling for a timeout. It's second, and we'll have one left, 437 left.
Why does she play field hockey? She knows there will be no shoe commercials, no trading cards, no limos. So why? Because she is an athlete. Just like a football player, just like a basketball player, just like a baseball player. GTE is proud to be the official telecommunications consultant to the NCAA and the Pac-10 because of her and the pure spirit of college athletics.
It takes a little longer to pour a beer as good as Sam Adams. Oh. Sam Adams, a better glass of beer.
He's worked almost 40 years. She's worked almost 40 years. And during that time, they've gone on walks together instead of cruises, and shared secrets together instead of champagne, just so that someday, they could retire and be together all the time. At Cigna, we care about the retirement dreams of over 5 million people. After all, there are dreams too. Cigna, a business of caring.
Well, a reminder, more college football next Saturday. Southern Miss will get it on with Memphis, and Tulane will go to Houston to do battle with the Cougars. That's next week on Fox Sports Nets. College football Saturday, we begin at 3:30 Eastern. Check your local listings for the game in your area. Arizona looking at a third down and less than 5 yards. Wildcats only 3 of 13 on third down conversions. You have to think, though, this could conceivably be two down territory here.
And I would conceivably look for a quarterback draw if I was Cal.
They run that play a lot with Keith Smith. Smith will put it up. Throws to the end zone for Northcott. No, incomplete. Chidi Uwama. Yeah, they're saying it's an incomplete pass.
Chidi Uwama did a great job trying to be argumentative with the referee, saying he came down with the football. Just again, a fade route. Northcutt looking for the ball, and Iwoma does get his head around this time. He sees the ball, and they both come down simultaneously. Iwoma, though, out of bounds. That's a good call. That's a good call by the referee. It's an awfully close call.
Very close call. 33-yard field goal here for McDonald. And is it going to get there? No. It is off to the right, and again, special teams rearing their ugly heads here in Tucson.
Dick Quinlan, our spotter, trying to loan me his glasses for that last replay, but Dick, I have 20/15 vision. I promise you he was out of bounds.
Well, it's been that kind of a year on special teams for both these teams, really. And Dick Tomey just saying, what are you going to do? I got a three-point lead with 4:27 left. I'll count on my defense. McDonald now 1 out of 3 in field goal attempts. He made a 27-yarder, and he missed a 35 and a 33, but he made a 35-yard extra point. So the Bears still breathing. Hand off this time to Tarik Smith, and he gets about 4. Jimmy Sprott makes the stop. Let's take another look at that play and see if your 2015 vision is right.
If Q would slide over those glasses again. You know, I would almost give this to Northcutt because he comes down with it. Oh, his foot's on the line. Iwoma's knee was on the line, and the field judge is right there to call it accurately out of bounds.
There's a give to White, and White is stopped. And it'll be 3rd down and 5 for the Bears. Running out of time here. They go with a double slot. Better checking off. Better short drop. Throws incomplete. Intended for Kofi Nardi. No flag.
Yes,
there
flag.
Is a flag. I'm sorry, I didn't see it. There is a flag, and that's going to be a big break for the Bears. Rashid Johnson on his back.
Yeah, Rashid Johnson, watch him as he ends
pass
up.
Pass interference on he's the gonna, defense. The ball will be placed at the spot of the foul, first down.
He's going to ride the player out of bounds. Watch it, just a quick little turnout. Rashid Johnson comes through the receiver. Sure enough, draws the flag.
Big break for California. I think it probably was the outside arm, actually. Got one hand up over the shoulder, and then maybe the other hand on the shoulder, not to mention the body. There's a slant for Douglas, makes the catch, close to a first down. It is a first down across the 40-yard line. That's been the Bears' most effective pass play tonight. That's Douglas's 9th catch.
Damian Douglas came in with 30 at 39 on the year, and he's getting to know this DBs real well from Arizona. They've done a lot of jawing back and forth, but you can stop the jawing because what you need right now, you need a score, and you got to just keep working the clock and working the chains down the field.
They give it to Tarik Smith, and Smith getting good first down yardage, close to midfield, a gain of 9. Chester Burnett makes the tackle, 2nd and short for the Bears.
There's nothing wrong with running the football every now and then in a 2-minute offense, but you got to get on the line of scrimmage and run another play. I'm not sure what they're doing right here by huddling up when time is so crucial.
2 minutes, 30 seconds. Bears have 2 timeouts, Arizona 1. Here comes a blitz. Better hit as he threw, and it's incomplete, intended for Douglas. Well, Better saw it coming and unloaded the ball quickly. Chester Burnett right in his face.
And hats off to Better just for recognition and getting the ball off. We've seen so many times a quarterback doesn't have great speed from center, and Chester Burnett's one of the fastest linebackers in the Pac-10, but just for Better to fire the ball out of bounds, he knows it's either going to be an incompletion or no one's going to, you know, I mean, it's either a great catch or it's just out of bounds.
Third down and short. So the Bears got to think about a first down first. They give it to White, the fullback, and he breaks it. He has the first down. At the 47-yard line of Arizona, Marcus Bell makes the tackle. Now the clock will stop while the chains move. And again, the Bears don't seem to be in any great hurry here.
No, and I would really be leaning on the line of scrimmage. And when I say that, I wouldn't be huddling. I would call my plays from the line of scrimmage, make Arizona line up and commit to what defense they're running, and then you can call a play from that alignment.
So Vetter will go up, he throws, and that should be interference again. It's not on Kelly Malvo. So I'll stop being an official here. To me, like Malvo had them all wrapped up.
Kelly Malvo this time with good coverage on Douglas. Douglas coming in, and Barry, you saw it. He did hold him up just a little bit. Malvo with a little bit of culprit hands across the jersey of number five Douglas that time.
Slot right on second down and 10. And they give the ball to Tarek Smith, who almost forgot to take the ball. Joe Tafoya makes the stop, and it's going to be third down and about six.
And one name that we just haven't called in the second half, Bobby Shaw. Throw the ball to Bobby Shaw. I know Tommy Holmes thinking, okay, well, we got third down. We need a key third down. Get the ball to the go-to guy. And, of course, Bobby Shaw's locked up with Chris McAllister. Go the other way. Go to number five.
As he has been all night. Vetter looking to the left. Throws for Douglas again. First down, Bears out of bounds the 35-yard line. And Douglas has been the go-to guy tonight, and he's making the most of his moment.
I think what you have to do, though, I still, as Damian Douglas comes up limping, possibly an ankle, he got rifled into the sideline pretty well, and he's down.
And that may cost the Bears a timeout here. Right now it's an official timeout while they tend to Damian Douglas. Malvo gave him a real shot going out of bounds. But a clean shot, I believe.
Was a clean shot, a speed out. Vetter does a great job getting the ball off on time. Kelly Malvo just, oh yeah, you see his foot got caught in the turf. If you can hold it right as he goes out of bounds, you're gonna see his foot right there. And it just twists as he goes out of bounds. Well, his cleats got stuck in the turf right then and there. Now you have to go to Bobby Shaw. You don't have a choice.
Well, Douglas sitting up. Damian Douglas, very personable young guy. Talked to us when we were up in Berkeley for the Oklahoma game. Said, refer to me as D1, and he appears to be all right. Playing the way he has played tonight, I guess he deserves to be called whatever he wants to be called.
I told him last night, he said, yeah, I got 30 catches, but I want to get over 40. I said, hey, if you end up with 40, that's a great year. Well, he's got his 40.
Yes, he does. And he's made all the big catches for California today. All the third down plays.
I think what you have to do, maybe put Bobby Shaw in the slot, but right now Bobby Shaw's going to the split end. Actually, again, at flanker. But he lines up against Kelly Malvo.
Now they start in motion. Here comes the blitz. And they pick it up. Vetter now trying to scramble away. Buys himself some time. But they're trying to get to the sideline. And is run down at the 38-yard line by Marcus Bell. And again, that's recovery speed defensively that made that play for Arizona. We'll take a timeout. 1 minute, 11 seconds remaining. 31-28 Arizona.
There are people who think water polo is not a game for a man. They're right. This is no game, and he is not just a man. It is a sport, and he is an athlete, just like a football player, just like a basketball player, just like a baseball player. GTE is proud to be the official telecommunications consultant to the NCAA and the Pac-10 because of him and the pure spirit of college athletics.
You got the wrong guy. Whoa. Oh.
boy, you're tall. Can I get you a beer?
Oh, it's Sam Adams.
There are times when only a perfect glass of beer will do.
That's a good one, Grim.
Sam Adams, a better glass of beer.
Coming up after the game, Fox Sports News will tell you all about that UCLA-Washington game. Terrific game today in the Rose Bowl. Sellout, incidentally. The Bulls and the Cavs have at one another again. And Jacques Demers taking control down in Tampa. That's Fox Sports News coming up after the game. Well, there is a look at Tim Wolick, and the question is, A, will he get a chance, and B, if the Bears get a chance, will it be Tim Wolick, or will it be Ignacio Brashe? First things first, second down at 13. Toss out of bounds. Kofi Nardi did not get the foot down. He made the catch, forgot about where his feet were.
What's interesting, when you predetermine your throws, that time going to Nardi, and Nardi was lined up against McAllister. You had the matchup you wanted if you wanted one. You had Shaw against Malvo on the other side of the field. Again, Cal starting this drive at their own 20. They've reeled off 11 plays, and again, third down and long. Keep your eye on the clock as well.
107 remaining in the football game. Ball is caught this time by Nardi, and he's going to have a first down at the 19, at the 24-yard line. And the clock now at 1 minute. If it is a first down, now the clock will stop. They will move the chains. And the best thing that happened to California, actually, is if they have to take a measurement. But they won't. It's a first down. Now the Bears will come right to the line of scrimmage here.
You know, the clock has to wait till the chains are set. So again, they benefit by that.
And the clock starts again. And the toss intended for Pierre, and turning into a defensive player that time was Pierre, and he did a nice job to keep the ball away from Kelly Malvo.
Malvo makes a great play. He almost comes down with the interception, but a better play, as you mentioned, by Bruce Pierre, able to jar the ball free and not allow the interception. Again, I think you find your go-to guy somehow, some way. You get the ball into number three's hand, and I may add, Damian Douglas back in the game for the Cal Bears.
And Douglas starts in motion. Straight back goes Benner. He throws, and it is caught and dropped by Douglas, but they're going to say a catch. They'll say he caught it at the 3-yard line. Well, Damian Douglas has had a career night tonight. And now the Bears in a situation where they could conceivably win the football game.
Watch Douglas. He frees up, and he just runs a little shake route. And he turns Rashid Johnson completely around. And Vetter, with a great throw, going right over the top of Chris McAllister.
Did a great job, too, to hang on to that football. I thought he dropped it when his arm went over his head. First down, Bears at the 3. Vetter looks to the end zone, throws to Smith, dropped the ball. It was a touchdown, and he dropped it. And in microcosm, that has been the California football season.
Boy, if there's one play, they got exactly what they want right here. Two men in the flat, one stretching the defense, one right along the end line. Tarik Smith, drop.
And there are 23 seconds left in the game. Typical Cal-Arizona football game. And the Wildcats are going to use their last timeout. Bears still have one timeout remaining.
Tom Holmes says, thank you very much. I would have loved to have used a timeout there, but if Dick Tomey wants to call one, that's okay. I think what you have to be conscious of right here, Barry, if you're running the football, you want to center it into the middle of the field, and you don't want to be on a hash mark in case you have to kick a field goal.
Well, again, the Bears have missed 7 extra points this year, and you're absolutely right. That angle gets more severe when you're down that far. So what do you do?
I think you run the ball towards the middle of the field. I think you really have to be conscious of the fact that if you can run 2 plays, You have a second and a third down play. You got to be, if you run, if you pile up, getting off the pile and then running another play and calling a timeout, you're going to be awfully close to about 3 seconds on the clock. But I think you play it safe. I think you get the ball into the middle of the field. You try to score. But if you don't score, you run right behind your left tackle, John Wellborn, the big junior from Peninsula High out of beautiful Palos Verdes. And I tell you, that's the run you make and give Tarik Smith a little time to make up for a miscue.
16th play of this drive, 23 seconds left. The Bears need 3 yards. They pitch on the sweep. Smith will not get there, and he stopped at the 5-yard line, and they are going to have that angle. Now they have another play to use here, too.
Mind-boggling. Now I'll tell you why. You run into the short side of the field, you're playing right into the Arizona defense. They run with great team speed. They want you to run to the short side of the field. They can corral you.
So now the Bears have used their last time out. Now the problem for California is they are not going to be able to get the ball centered unless they just want to take a chance on a running play. But if they do that, they probably are not going to be able to stop the clock if the play doesn't get you into the end zone. So now they got to put the ball up. If they don't convert that into a touchdown, then the field goal is going to come from that angle that we spoke of.
Doug Cosby, you see him right there. The tall coach, Doug Cosby, a great tight end for a long time with the Dallas Cowboys. He's the offensive coordinator, and he's telling his guys, look, this is what you need to do. Justin, make sure you spin the ball out. If your guy can't catch it, it goes into the ground.
18 seconds left in the game. 31-28, Arizona over California. Justin Vetter now 22 of 36, 222 yards, and a touchdown, but he needs one more. He has White and Smith in the backfield. Vetter straight back, looks for Smith. Running out of room, running out of time, throws it out of bounds. And now the Bears will just try to tie it. And it's not going to be easy.
And that was the same play that Tarik Smith dropped a few plays ago. They ran the same play. It's a run formation. This time Arizona and the Arizona defense really had it defensed well. They were right on top of Tarik Smith and Brian Surgener, the tight end. And Tim Wallach will come on his first field goal attempt this season. I don't imagine he's nervous.
No. His heart beating like a hummingbird, I'm sure, out of the hold of Shaw. 22 yards to force an overtime.
And a horrible angle.
He got it up. He made it good. And we are tied at 31.
This is your typical Cal Arizona game.
It's amazing.
And you thought I got excited for a moment. Why?
He'll jump away. 8 seconds left. Tied at 31.
Enterprise, rent a car for my trip?
Looks expensive.
It's not expensive, Mom.
They pick us up? Sounds expensive.
Pickup's free, Mom.
Well, if it's not expensive, why didn't I get a convertible?
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Serve.
You can give this kid a life.
Don't die in here.
No matter the cost.
What did I do? What did I do?
NYPD Blue, part of the best primetime on cable. 5 nights a week, only on FX.
Well, Wallach, the 22-yarder to tie the game at 31 with 8 ticks left. So don't go anywhere. There's still 8 seconds left. I would imagine they will just dribble this one down. Or maybe try to pop it.
Yeah, I think you drive it down.
Well, they went for the dribble. Northcutt just falls on it. Now there's 6 seconds left, and I don't imagine Arizona will try anything fancy here. Well, last year, four overtimes, 56-55.
Just a kind of a ho-hummer.
Yeah.
Just like this one. Well, I think it's attributable to both teams coming in. They know they're going to play pretty evenly. They have the same type of athlete. And they're not at that top echelon, neither team, at the Pac-10. But take a look at the last 10 games. That's pretty impressive.
Yep. And the favorite has lost 6 of 9. Smith takes a knee, and this is deja vu.
Well, both quarterbacks have done a great job, and to get him in this position, and Keith Smith has done a wonderful job in the second half, and Justin Vetter, that was an awfully nice drive. Of course, the drop ball, Tarik Smith may come back to haunt him, but they got a good chance here in overtime.
So Tom Homo, interesting enough, we were sitting at breakfast with Tom Homo this morning, talking about last year's game and what a throat clutcher it was, and here he is all over again in the same situation.
Last year, of course, Tommy Homo, the defensive coordinator for Steve Mariucci's Cal team that went into four overtimes. Pat Barnes throwing for 8 touchdowns. Keith Smith setting a freshman record, over 500 yards total offense in one game. And Dick Tomey, of course, on the steering committee to get rid of all those multiple overtime games.
So let's take a look at the rules of overtime. They will alternate possessions from the opponent's 25-yard line after the second overtime. In other words, starting in the third overtime, you have to go for a two-point conversion. And as we said, last year's four overtime game here had a lot to do with it.
And I may add, usually when they come out for the coin toss right now, if you win the toss, what has been the kind of the acceptable way has been to go on defense first. And I have always argued that. I think you take the ball and you go on offense first because you set the precedence. Why not be the one to go down and score first?
But if you come up empty and you know you only need a field goal, wouldn't that change the strategy?
Go ahead. Want defense?
You want to be on defense.
See how the referee. You want defense.
Put your backs, okay?
So the Bears will play defense first.
California won the toss.
And with that, we will take a break. Overtime coming up at Arizona Stadium, 31-31.
Papa's got a brand new bag.
Nothing catches your eye like the more luxurious 200 horsepower Accord V6. An Accord like no other.
You'll call it your window of opportunity.
And there's one thing that's bound to attract a crowd. Festive decorations? Maybe.
Pretty lights? Whoa.
How about saving money?
It's the Chevy Make Your Money Count year-end event where you can get low 1.9 APR financing or a great smart lease on a huge selection of Chevy cars and trucks. So don't forget, make your money count now at your Chevy dealer and save big.
1.9% financing. Get it at your Southern California Chevrolet dealer now.
Welcome back, ladies. I trust you had a great summer. Professor Casey Jones in the house. How did you spend your summer vacations, Miss Rosati?
I did drill after drill.
I had a picnic with some fans.
I pumped up for the season.
I relaxed with a game of golf.
Miss Steele?
I took a family trip. Did a little modeling.
got ready to kick rookie butt.
But now it's time for basketball season.
Portland meets Colorado, Sunday at 4 on Fox Sports West.
I wonder what implications socioeconomic maladies would have in a capitalist environment.
I wonder who started the end zone victory dance.
NFL Total Access. Ron Pitts and Tim Green show you who's hot and who's not in the NFL. Plus, get wired in and hear what the playmakers are really up to.
I wonder if the Jets can win the Super Bowl.
NFL Total Access. Tuesday, followed by Hardcore Football on Fox Sports West.
Well, we did this last year. We're going to do it again this year. Let's one more time look back on last year. We ended in a tie at 35. Keith Smith looks for Jeremy McDaniel. 25 yards out. Touchdown. That put Arizona into the lead. California coming right back. Pat Barnes, the quarterback. Douglas, once again, who's had a huge night tonight. The touchdown here. That tied it again at 42. But it was Keith Smith right back. This time he did it with his feet rather than his arm. Took it in from 11 yards out. That made it 49-42. It was the Bears' turn to answer. Barnes to Vera, 10 yards and a touchdown. Tied at 49. Barnes to Vera once again for California. That made it 56-49. And then after an Arizona tie, what appeared to be a tying touchdown, they faked the extra point try, went for two. Bears snuffed it out, and with that, California wins it 56-55. Here we are again, tied at 31. We're live at Arizona Stadium. First play from the 25-yard line of the overtime period. Smith out of the shotgun. He'll run and won't go anywhere. Stop back at the 30-yard line by Andre Carter, who makes the biggest play he's made tonight. Always have to respect that quarterback draw with Keith Smith at that position.
Andre Carter that time really stepping up big, the true freshman. 6'4 and 250 pounds. We haven't called his name a lot tonight, but that's a key play in this overtime. It's interesting, Arizona will, if they're in any length of a field goal situation, they'll go for it on fourth down.
Second down and 15 now. Smith will throw. And he's got Brennan, and Brennan's out of bounds at the 7-yard line, first down. Well, much as Douglas has been the go-to guy for California, Brad Brennan has been the go-to guy for Arizona.
Brennan lines up in the slot, and what ends up happening, they run a little shake and corner, and Keith Smith again just fires the ball. He does a great job getting the ball outside to Brennan. And picking up a big portion of yardage up the field inside the 10-yard line.
He also had Rodney Williams open on a post that time. He had his choice. Ball at the 7-yard line. First down. First possession of the overtime. We're tied at 31. Bears show blitz. They come with a blitz. The handoff is to Kelvin Ephon, and he gets it to about the 6-yard line. Matt Beck wraps him up. It'll be second down and goal.
Ephon almost broke it. He did a nice job of letting the blocking develop in front of him, and he got banged up a little bit himself as he goes off the field hobbling. But Arizona again, their offensive line has done a great job in the second half controlling that defensive line of Cal that came in with a lot of promise. But right now that offensive line is going to have to create a big hole to get somebody in the end zone.
Out of the shotgun again, hitting the running back now. Smith, a floater to Northcutt in the end zone. Did he get it? Yes, touchdown Arizona. And Northcutt went down hard. And now he gets up, he's all right. Now the try for points. So Arizona with the first score of the overtime.
Well, they don't take many plays to get the touchdown. Keith Smith, just a little fade route to Dennis Northcutt. Dennis Northcutt knows exactly where he is on the field. He does a great job of dragging the back foot, although his front foot came down on the end line.
I don't know about that one. Try for point is up and good. And it is a 38-31 ball game, and now we'll go the other way. Northcutt's third touchdown, and it was close. Let's take a look, see what you think.
Keith Smith out of the shotgun again, just a quick throw. Watch where Dennis Northcutt's right foot comes down. Right there, his left foot's dragging. That is definitely a score.
Yep.
And he's still dragging it. He gets pushed out of bounds by Kato Soranga.
That's a great play by Northcutt to get that drag foot down.
Boy, do we have angles for you? We got every angle imaginable. And Northcutt skying. See, actually both feet down, dragging the foot. Touchdown pass.
So the Bears start at the 25. Vera is the lone setback, and Vetter will go up. Vetter in trouble. Now he's going to run. He's got a lot of room. He's the 20. He's the 10. The 5, and stopped at the 3-yard line. So Vetter picks up 22 on first down.
Great gamesmanship that time by Justin Vetter. He saw a crease, and knowing the pursuit angles of the Arizona defense, he elected to just pull it down and take off running. And great decision that time by number 10, the JC transfer quarterback. And he almost outruns the defense, but Chester Burnett, the great linebacker and a big-time sprinter himself, able to drag it down from behind.
Defensive speed once again. Smith and White in the backfield. They give it to Smith, trying to cut inside, and he's in. Touchdown, Bears. So both teams scoring quickly here in the first overtime. And now the try for point. Now, normally you think that's just the period at the end of the sentence, but in many cases this year for California, as they take a timeout. And I wonder if that timeout is being taken to decide whether or not to go for 2 points here.
Tarik Smith just following his lead blockers. They pull the two guards, and Tarik Smith able to carry David Phipp into the end zone.
Do you have trouble driving in the rain? Is the glare unbearable at night? That's why STP created Vision Blade glass treatment. Vision Blade forms an invisible barrier that repels water and virtually eliminates glare. It applies in minutes and lasts for 6 months, so there's no need to reapply over and over. Look, this muddy water sticks to the glass on the untreated side, but with Vision Blade, the dirt and grime sheets away and your view remains clear. See what you've been missing with Vision Blade.
Outlined against a blue-gray sky, the lone horseman rides again. A man who stands for all that is college football. His blood is UCLA Bruin blue entering his heart and Ball State red going out. His gums are Texas burnt orange, his teeth Georgia Tech yellow, but he...
Well, the Bears have decided that they are going to go for 2 points, and now Arizona is going to take a timeout and let the Bears think about it a little bit more. California had come to the line of scrimmage and lined up to go for two and either win it or lose it right here. And I'm sure that is born in some part, at least, of the fact that the kicking game for the Bears has been so erratic. Tom Homo called his entire team over to the huddle. And they're just going to live and die. Live by the sword, die by the sword. That's what Tom Homo is saying to his team.
And I think a lot of things factor into this decision as well. Defensively, they're not as healthy as they want to be. They don't have the 11 guys really they want out there on the field. And Arizona has shown the capability to make the big play when they need to. Although right now, Tommy Homo calling Wallach back onto the field to possibly kick this extra point. So now they're kind of going back and forth, playing a little cat and mouse with Dick Tomey.
There's a heated debate going on down there of exactly what the Bears will do. And they're going to have to decide very quickly. We'll remind you, while they do decide, the executive producers of Fox Sports Net are Arthur Smith and Bill Borson. The coordinating producer of College Football Saturday is Gary Garcia. Tonight's game produced by Jerry Romano and directed by Doug Freeman. College Football Saturday show produced by Mark Huska and directed by Brad Toberman. The head of field operations is Andrea Jenkins.
Remember, the only overtime this year for both the teams, Arizona lost up at Washington State in double overtime as they went for two on their second possession of the overtime, and Ortiz Jenkins was caught short of the goal line. But right now, Cal lining up to kick the extra point.
They got 4 seconds to get it off. Now they're going to kick it and go for one and play for the tie. 2 seconds. One. And now they have to make it a longer extra point. And that falls into the category of unforgivable.
On the offense, 5 yards.
That is absolute chaos.
Well, you see Tom Homo wanting an explanation as to why that can happen. And if it's up to him, that probably won't happen again in any game management situation.
Even now, they got 13 seconds, 12, 11, 10, and it becomes a 25-yard extra point. This to force a second overtime. 3 seconds, 2, 1. They got the snap, high snap. They got it down, the kick is up and good. And it wasn't very pretty, but it was up and good, and we're going on. That is an absolute look of relief on the part of Wallach, the kicker.
Bobby Shaw says, that's okay, we might need you again now. Focus, stay focused.
So now the Bears go back on defense, and Arizona will go back on offense. Tied at 38, second overtime. High snap, nice job by Shaw to get it down and get the ball turned.
Tim Wallach, he just, the heart monitor was thumping.
Oh, my. I don't know if he's got another one of those in him, to tell you the truth. I really believe that Tom Homo, should Arizona score and should the Bears score again, I realize that's a lot of wouldas and couldas and shouldas, would likely go for two.
And remember, one OT down at the end of this second OT. If they end up in a tie again, as they go into that third OT, if a team scores, they have to go for two. So they always have two-point plays. They work on them all year long, and rarely do they get the opportunity to run them.
Well, and remember, the Bears had a two-point play earlier in this ball game, and it was a very effective play for them.
Exactly, and I'm sure that's just one of about 5 or 6 two-point plays they have. And again, what will happen right now, they come out for another coin toss to decide who gets the ball first. Really, who goes on defense first? Actually, there won't be a coin toss. There will just be a determination.
Arizona has chosen to go on defense during the second overtime. It'll be first and 10 for California that direction.
They rotate as to who gets the option of having the ball or going on defense. Arizona, having lost the first toss, they get the election. The second overtime, they elect to go back on the defense.
So the Bears will go on offense. We'll be going in the other direction this time. This is the second overtime that Arizona's played. They played one up in Washington State and wound up on a short end as they were unable to convert a two-point conversion.
I think it's important, though, having had an opportunity to play an OT game during the course of the season, it just gives your team that much added experience in this kind of situation.
A lot of emotion being left on this field, too. Bears start at the 25-yard line. This could give you a real high going into the big game next week. Blitz comes. Vetter has to roll away and throws it away. That should be grounding. But they say he got outside the tackle, so it's not going to be grounding. If you're out of the pocket, it's not grounding.
Justin Vetter has really played heady this game. I mean, he's a bright kid coming in, but he saved some big plays for them. And that right there is saving a big play. He was working to the side of Shaw and Douglas, and they were working their magic. But when the blitz came, the offensive line just unable to pick up all the attackers.
So it'll be second down at 10. The ball at the 25. That's where we start. Blitz comes again. And Vetter gets away again, and now he will try to run. He steps up, and now he goes down at the 23-yard line. Now it's going to be 3rd and 8.
Vetter's been heady all night, but Rich Ellerson, the defensive coordinator, is taking chances, and watch as the free safety. Actually, it's this man right here. Fitt comes in and creates a play, and Vetter just doing a good job just getting back inside the line of scrimmage.
So it'll be 3rd and 8. They come to the blitz again. Vetter throws through behind the intended receiver, Bruce Pierre. Now what do you do? Do you go for the three, which the Bears are going to do? And again, Wallach comes onto the field, and he just made his first career field goal in his first career attempt to tie this game, and now he's looking at about a 41-yarder.
Getting that hard stumping, but he actually has a pretty good angle this time. He could drive it off the left hash. He's about a yard or two off it. Pretty straightforward.
And he missed it badly. Short and off to the left, never had a chance. So now Arizona can be the masters of their own fate. And it'll be up to the California defense to try to maintain for the Bears.
Tim Walling. The ball gets down. Bobby Shaw puts the ball down well, and Walling just hooks. Boy, that's an errant golf shot.
Yeah, that was, and it was a good snap and a good hold, so that's just on the kicker. Well, we opened this show by talking about special teams and what a factor they could be. And they have been just that.
Yeah, the man of the hour right here, number 12, Keith Smith. He comes in, home field advantage here, and running out of the shotgun, they have an array of weapons to run by.
But they, too, have some kicking problems. So here's a slant to Northcutt. Northcutt is dropped right at the line of scrimmage. Sekou Sanyika makes the tackle for the Bears, maybe gained a yard. Northcutt, remember, already with three touchdowns in the game. Schmidtke comes back into the ball game at a running back spot. The Doe comes in also at the wideout.
And Brennan has been the one effective out of the slot, racing down the middle all evening.
They give to Schmidtke on second down, and he's wrapped up after a gain of about a yard. It's going to be third down and nine for the Wildcats. Andre Carter and Brandon Whiting step up and make a play.
Again, I think you get in shotgun formation and you spread out the defense and you give Keith Smith the runner pass option. He can pick up 9 yards in a hurry with his legs, but you really have to spread out the Bear defense and utilize your speed on offense.
So they go out of the shotgun on third down and nine. Smith will throw with Ty. Throws for Elf Ifon out of the backfield, and a great job that time to hang on by Matt Beck. And so now the same problem that was presented to California is presented to Arizona. Do you bring your kicker on who has not made a kick of longer than 33 yards this entire season? And that is what Dick Tomey has opted to do, much as that was what Tom Homo opted to do, and this is going to be a 43-yarder for McDonald.
That was a dangerous throw that time. Mark McDonald out of Loyola High, L.A.
Bears are going to take a timeout here, Rams. So now McDonald will try to do what Wallach was not able to come even close to, and he hasn't come close to it all year. We're coming back.
Papa's got a brand new bag.
Weeknights on FX, the best primetime on cable. First at 8, they captured our imagination.
If it's not human, what is it?
And became a phenomenon. David Duchovny and Gillian Anderson star in The X-Files. Then at 9, Dennis Franz, David Caruso, Jimmy Smits, Kim Delaney. The show that was nominated for over 50 Emmys, NYPD Blue. Weeknights, FX has the best primetime on cable. The X-Files and NYPD Blue, 5 nights a week.
Next week on College Football Saturday, Southern Miss will get it on with Memphis, or Tulane will go to Houston to battle the Cougars. That's next week on Fox Sports Nets, College Football Saturday, 3:30 Eastern. Check your local listings for the game in your area. So Mark McDonald will try a 43-yard field goal to win it for Arizona. Now McDonald's longest, as we said, 33-yard. I'm not sure he's made a 43-yarder on the playground. Snap, kick, got a lot on it. It's got a chance. It's good! A fitting end, Rams.
Really is a fitting end, and you see Tommy Homo looking for Dick Tomey, but Dick Tomey, I really believe it. They had the experience in the OT game earlier this year. They were able to pull this one off.
So that's a wrap. Arizona wins it in double OT. 41-38. For Tom Ramsey and Carol Lewis, I'm Barry Tompkins. Stay tuned now for Fox Sports News. It's coming up next.